And there we are.
So, right, yes. There's Always a Tavern is now the official title of the play sessions.
And for your information, players, we are going to be on screen. On screen!
Welcome to anybody watching live. Anybody not watching live, then welcome to you. So, after playing the starter set, you should all now have wonderful, sparkly, shiny character sheets of your own design. And we are in a world of my own design.
Don't be afraid.
So there's a certain calendar. It's kind of like the Forgotten Realms, but it's not quite. If you have any sort of specific questions as to lore, history-wise, or you know, things that have happened, or why something is something, then feel free to ask. If it's general sort of knowledge, then I'll tell you. If it's more specific, we'll do a skill check, history, arcana, whatever it may be. But the current year is the 440th
year SC.
Well, the obvious question, I suppose, the elephant in the room, as it were, is the whole dark elf issue.
Is there a dark elf issue? Do we have a racist wood elf in our midst?
Yeah, that's a racist.
We've got a wood elf in our midst. That basically means that there is definitely a racist wood elf in our midst.
I'm just asking in the context of this universe. Of this world. Or was it just that dark elves happen to like living underground and that's it?
No, dark elves are generally considered evil. They do reside in the Underdark. They do abuse creatures who they deem to be lower, a bit like any elf, really.
Hey!
Shockwell.
Oh, it works both ways. I see it now. Racism works both ways.
Oh, yeah. Especially when it comes to
finally. I wouldn't know. I'm a gnome. I love everybody.
Whatever costs you.
As long as they're giving you gold, ore, and mead. But yes, we'll. If you have any specific questions about the world now that would be in a general knowledge, any sort of questions, feel free to ask now, and I shall fill you in.
I have one question.
Yes.
What 440 SC. Yes. What month are we in? Are we in January or are we in...
Ah, my apologies. Right. In your playouts on Roll 20, you should see calendar reference. If you do not, tell me now.
Yeah, got it.
And if you open it up, you will see that... The months are altered slightly. They generally follow what happens in that month's theme. And we are currently in Newflower, on the fourth day of Newflower. So the campaign world is technically starting on the same day as the real world. As it is Star Wars Day!
Indeed.
Yay!
Yay. Newflower, the fourth, be with you.
Oh. Indeed. So yes, January is otherwise known in the game campaign world as Frosthold. February is Frost Death. March is Newgrass. April is Sungrow. May is Newflower. June is Long Suns, with quite a long day, with 16 hours of sunlight. July is Never Dark, which the drow might find particularly unpleasant because there's 20 hours of sunlight in the day.
Yeah.
August is Twins Fall, because there are two suns in this world. However, they're only both dominant in the sky during Never Dark. September is New Harvest, Autumn Equinox. October is Red Tree. November is Snowfall, and December is the... favourite for the drow, as that is Long Dark, with only 4 hours of daylight, and there are two moons in the sky. The traditional moon and the wraith moon.
Well, that's horrifying. No offense.
So that's your calendar, your month cycle. Follows the same as our actual calendar, so the days of the month, just to keep things a little less complicated. In terms of magic use, magic was technically sort of banned due to a large incident in the year 220 SC, which caused almost a cataclysmic event in the centre of the Verashi continent, which kind of set the tone for magic users. So it's not outright banned, however, anyone who is a mage or a sorcerer or anything like that needs to undergo rigorous studying by a royally appointed university of magic, and they're generally sort of not seen in the wilds as much. There are many clerics and druids and things like that, people who use magic and faith-based honor, but again, they're few and far between. Keep it under their hat in case common
confusion.
People shout, "Burn the witch!" because of the magical cataclysm, the whole thing started, unfortunately, with an adventuring party that was primarily wizard-based. So in the year 231 SC, by royal decree, all adventuring parties must have a certificate of license that allows them to adventure and use certain adventuring ways, you know, magic use and stuff like that.
Right.
And anyone who is a lord or, you know, viscount, whatever, anyone who runs a parcel of land or an island or something like that can sponsor or put their seal on a license, and they are generally accepted across the realms, although it's normally advisable to make yourselves known to a magistrate and or the reigning sort of lord, saying, "Hello, we are," and saying, "This is our license, please don't kill us." But yes, it just so happens, and we'll get to the actual introduction for your party, whether you were born there or whether you just happen to live there, you are currently setting off from the Isle of Windstone, which is a rather small island. If you think in terms of scale, it is the Isle of Wight to the United Kingdom. Mm-hmm. So you've formed together somehow or another. You've met in the local pub, a tavern, because there is always one. Yeah. And you've decided that, you know, you're a pretty good match of skill set, and you play off each other quite well. And you've formed this little band, you've done your trial by fire, where the lord who says, "Right, you want a license? Well, you need to go and get in that dungeon for me and get me some gold." You've done that bit, and you've plundered the depths of little there are in Windstone, and you're looking for fame, fortune, wealth, whatever your personal goal may be, on the mainland of Verash. And it's at this point I will put it to you to introduce your characters. Bonus points and quite possibly experience for exceptional performances of your characters.
Before we do that, can I ask a few questions?
You may. Feel free.
Well, one thing. What does the SC Sumerian calendar, is that just, why is it 440 years?
It's 440 years since the Sumerian calendar was implemented. Before that, people just used summers and winters to gauge what had passed.
sort of start of this civilization, essentially.
Essentially, yeah. A very wise wizard went to the royal court and said, look, let's be serious here. We need a proper gauge of time, and everybody knows when they can have a bank holiday.
Okay. That's a severe wizard.
How big and varied is this, I suppose, and is it...
Say again?
How big and varied is this continent we're on? Well, we're near.
I think the scale of Verash is, again, it's almost the United Kingdom, but it's a little bit larger. I haven't actually drawn it out yet.
Yes.
But I will give you a full scale of it. There's a very fragmented world, but the largest sort of singular continent is Verash.
Alright, final question.
Mm-hmm.
What are the seas like, and what are the other more common foreign lands like, in case you want to say we're from some other far-flung place?
Ooh, interesting. I knew you'd be the one to ask the questions that I didn't have a bullet point for.
Because two of us are also sailors, so that kind of implies that there could
be some foreign... Yeah, no, fair enough. In your sailor background, does it specify anything, or is it just...
No, because I didn't have any idea.
Oh, fair. No, that's fine. So, on the continent sort of side, the western... well, if we go initially, rough guide of the UK, slightly larger on the western side. To the east is your standard sort of east with Arabic type people. I think they're... Is it the Qumtai or something like that in the Forgotten Realms?
Interesting.
You've got the Red Priests, which is Thay in the Forgotten Realms, is in the hot part of the world, like the Middle East, which is Yataka. Y-A-T-A-K-A.
So not from there, probably, if I'm going to be a wood elf.
No, probably not. Wood elf-wise, to the south of the equator is Somalia. Not Somalia. but that is quite forested. There's a lot of twig-blight activity and waken trees and crazy druids and wood nymphs and elven folk.
That sounds nice. How do you spell that?
S-A-M-A-L-A. S-
Ooh.
A-L-A.
Manny. My tweet got a favourite.
Yay.
Yeah, me too.
So, yes.
I have a question, if I may.
You may.
You said you need a lord or a viscount or somebody to sign the licence.
Yes.
Who is it who signed our license?
That would be Lord Boris Newstone.
Of Winston.
Boris Newstone III.
It should be in your handouts, is it not?
Yeah, it is, yeah. To adventure in the kingdom of Verash, its independent islands, and associated planes of existence. Wow, that's a bit of a...
The plane of existence. It's the formality, you know. It's good. He just puts his stamp on it. The magistrate writes the names in.
But all I'm saying is I am not dressed to go through any interdimensional portals right now.
I am a bit naked.
You're fine. What?
Parallel dimensions does tend to lead to total party kills, so yeah, I'm okay with that.
I'm just saying, I'm going to need like at least a week to prepare, you know, to make sure I've got enough cloaks and...
Brown trousers.
Never have enough brown trousers.
I do not. I've only got two sets of clothes. That ain't good. Yeah, well.
Right. So, any further questions of that you could associate with your backgrounds or whatever? I shall endeavour to. Go on.
I'm supposed to be Damaran. What's Damara like?
Brown sugar?
Ha!
No, so you've used that, obviously, because you had nothing to go on from Forgotten Realms.
Right.
What's the context, my dear?
Well, it says... it's just a race in the Faerun, the Marans. I don't know.
Very well. We shall come back to that.
Ignore it. Paying attention. Okay.
Is that where that's from your human race? Yeah, human areas, or is that Paladin specific?
Yeah, it's humans.
Okay, Doc. So, any other questions while I look for that?
Well, I've got one final thing.
Yep.
In my background for just my own bonds and everything, I was taught in a sword and monk school, and it's got us. How it works is you get a badge telling you, basically says what school you're from.
Have you read that? What school are you?
It's School of the Dancing Leaf.
Ooh, okay. For some reason, I thought you might have been sneaky and gone shadow.
No.
Because
no.
You can see in the dark, and coincidentally, making shadows.
I'm not actually that stealthy, to be honest.
Cool. What was yours?
But how it works is that the idea that I had was, you have a badge, and for each monastery or school or teachings that you master, you get another badge, and so on.
Mm-hmm.
So it basically shows... So basically, if you lose or if you win, it shows, like, I'm so good, come to my school, or whatever.
No, fair enough.
And that's just my little bit of background thing, which I did.
No, that's cool.
And I don't know how common that would be, like, if I came from Somali, I don't know if monks here would do the same kind of thing with their schools, and so on.
No, that's more than, acceptable. They may. It all depends on the certain charter of, because there are many schools when it comes to monks. Some of them hire themselves out as the most skilled assassins, so there might be a fair few monks who have their own school as part of an assassin's guild hideout and stuff like that. But I like the pins idea. You should send me messages. I like that.
You can challenge another monk. And if you win, you get to tear his badge off him.
So a bit like the Dothraki with the braids.
Yeah. So if you lose it,
it doesn't hurt as much because you just go, "I've got your badge."
And if you lose it, you have to go back and re-own it essentially, or go beat off that guy and take it back.
That's cool. I like that.
I only have the one because you don't meet many monks on boats.
Well, they've got to get about it somehow.
Yeah. But things have been pretty chill for me over the last few years, so I'm happy.
Yeah, but it's slightly bad form, isn't it, if a monk's hired you to stale him somewhere, and then you're like, right, I'm going to kick your ass.
There's also, as a rule, monks don't normally do that to each other. Only
if they really give the nod.
Yeah. It's considered distasteful to do that kind of thing. So yeah, that's my bullshit. Feel free to do your own.
No, that's all cool. So yes, any other questions? Or would you like to get on to introducing your characters?
If we can crack on?
Yeah. Shall we... How do you want to do this? Shall we start with Geraldine, since she's in the front? And probably has the greatest personality of us, to be honest.
You could probably all hide behind me.
I can.
She's a big ass.
I don't know, Will.
Not that big. I'm just a huge...
But force of personality-wise, you're probably quite... You've kind of filled a room, I imagine.
With my glowing radiance.
Well, that's just how paladins are. You can't expect them to not... You don't really imagine a paladin sitting in the background.
No, you imagine them at the front reading the scripture.
Maybe, yeah.
Well, here we are, fellows. I suppose you ruffians would like a flagon of ale between you.
I don't know.
Wait. Flag them between us?
Yes. Stop being cheap. We've got things to do. Not sit around drinking.
I don't know if I should drink some.
Come, barkeep. Several flagons of ale for me and my companions. My companions.
Yeah. Alright. Yes.
I'll start epping. Excuse me.
Because I'd imagine a paladin having trouble flagging down a waiter. I'm just imagining one being ignored in the
because they're all girls. You know, girls never liked me. They never liked me!
This is why I became a paladin!
And also a kleptomaniac for some reason.
Everyone's a bit of a klepto sometimes.
Now, there's a joke about that, I can't remember what it is. Aha!
And like the shopkeeper from Mr. Ben, a wench appears.
Look at the rack on that!
Are you...
Sorry.
Getting late, right?
I found my bed for the night, lad. I don't know about you.
Is Geraldine a lady? Or man?
My bio and info has got a picture of what's her face? Of yeah. Tarth. Saying, I am no lady.
Right. Alright, that's... I don't know.
Right. So what we'll do is we'll Britain's Got Talented. we'll Verash has got talented. So who are you? What do you stand for?
Oh,
and all of that jazz.
The bard's gonna win.
He does.
Like I said, bonus points and possible XP for awesome execution of your character. If you want to do your character, if not, if you just want to give us the lowdown. Then you can miss out on juicy XP.
Okay, I balance my sword on my chair, jump upside down, and land on it head first. That is an awesome execution.
You're so
I have always wanted
introduction.
To watch an elf do that.
So, what I'm going to do, how many are there? There are six! Marvellous. That's perfect, because I have a d6 handy.
No, my goodness.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Taron, you are first.
Ah, damn it. The person that goes first never wins.
It's always the third one.
Okay, well, I am a wood elf called Taron Erynor. I can't even read my own name.
Erynor.
I should probably put in some hyphens there, just so I can say it phonetically. Yeah, anyway, average height, I'm 187 years old, so still fairly young. I'm a sailor, I've been going around the various little islands and everything for the last few years and everything. Got a little bit, picked up a bit of a bad drinking problem, so I try not to... Yeah, you don't really have much alcohol in Sunhollow. It's kind of not the kind you have here. I don't know how you do it different. But yeah, anyway, yeah. What I stand for, I am a monk, and there's typically three kinds of monks. There's the ones which are basically Avatar: The Last Airbender. There's the ones which are just shadowy, thiefy, teleporting maniacs. Who are kind of badass, but a bit emo-ish. Well, I, on the other hand, I'm more of the kind of kick-ass, badass, kung fu fighting guy. The clearly disappearing option. And I stand for freedom and being able to do what I want, really. So long as it doesn't screw up anyone else. I think people should be allowed to live their lives freely.
All right.
Oh, yeah, and I also basically want to see the world. I'm an elf. Unlike some other unfortunate places, I've got plenty of time, and I just want to explore.
So we have the kung fu lad who just wants to see it all, touch it all, and do naughty, naughty things.
Oh.
And can't have a sip of anything. You're a bit screwed, really, because there's no running water.
What, really?
Well, if you think the medieval sort of times, unless you can find a helpful wizard who will turn your dirty stagnant water to fresh.
Just no well.
there are wells, but it's not on tap. So, in drinking your stuff, look it. I'm sure they can ferment water.
What is milk?
Just as
would be milk.
Yeah, I was going to say, buy a goat.
I would like a yak.
You could ride it as well.
Alright, so thank you, Taron. Yeah, number one. Who is number one? Lisummer! Board it up!
Very well.
Do you need a beat box?
Do we catch you? Please, drop a beat. he's pretty young. He's in his early 20s. He's been doing the tavern circuit. I like to think that we all came together in the tavern to probably watch one of his gigs. With his sweet riffs and his Brian Johnson vocals. He is a bit egocentric, though. If he's not the centre of attention, he does get a bit pissed off, and he will just cut people off to draw the attention to him mid-conversation. I mean, he might have a bit of a Napoleon complex, because he's only 2'11". he favours the rapier and the crossbow, so he's a bit of a flashy, pretentious kid. Originally, he grew up in a relatively impoverished environment, and he went out to prove himself. He spent a lot of time on the streets, initially dabbling in petty theft, until his tastes and attentions were drawn to a more musical lilt. Frequenting the local alehouses and bars and taverns of the open areas, he learned his craft about singing, and eventually at 13 he bought his first lute, and he went from there. At a tender age of 17, he was employed as a wealthy family's personal bard. So he would play at functions and entertain the family at various dues and so forth. But things got a bit sticky for him at that point, because he kind of accidentally got himself engaged to the wealthy family's daughter. He kind of just did that to get in with her, effectively. Realised he got in too deep, and then he went on the run. And he's since then been trying to distance himself as much as possible from that said wealthy family. And he's also left-handed.
Where did that come from?
Marvellous!
Yeah, what a nice note to end it on. Our master left-handed.
Oh, by the way!
Left-handed. Well, FYI, left-handed. Isuma, awesome. That's him.
Awesome. So I do hope you appreciate the fact that you said that Lisummer sings.
Yes, he does. Yeah.
Marvellous.
And on the lute as well. You can shred some of those fat riffs. some pasty licks. Spin those.
Can he play Wonderwall?
Yes, he can. That was one of his first...
Would he like to forget how to play Wonderwall?
If only. He has been drinking heavily since.
So, from the Axeman to the Axeman, I suppose. Axhunath, would you like to tell us who you are, sir?
I am Axhunath. I am a barbarian. I enjoy the free. I enjoy freedom. The tyrants cannot be allowed to oppress people, and I will do that chaotically. I will literally go around and stab people for it. I was once given a horrible beating, and I will take my revenge on every single bully I encounter, including some of you people. I have a weakness as vice of the city, especially hard drink. So, anyone for a round? Anyone? Anyone at all? No. Pretty much it, except for I get bored very easily, so butterfly.
So you're a go-getter, really. You don't like hanging about. You just want to hit things with your axe.
Hit things, have a drink. What can you not love about that?
Depends on your point of view of the world, really. So you're a fighter, yes? Or barbarian, sorry.
Barbarian, yes.
Marvellous. Talking of barbaric acts, I think a gnome that is a fighter is a bit barbaric. They should be on the lawn, or next to a pond.
Look, I'm only playing a gnome fighter because some guy on the internet said I couldn't, so now I am, to prove him wrong.
Very well, Raif, tell us who you are.
I am Raif. I am a forest gnome, because quite frankly, I didn't find any use whatsoever for the Tinker Toy things, because, meh. I'm a former soldier, and I got sent away from my home of Lomark to go and reclaim my gnomish innocence, because I got a little bit heavy-handed with some thugs that tried to kill us. Personally, I didn't think I was heavy-handed enough, but, you know. So I've been sent away, and since being sent away, I actually had my own band of sellswords, which didn't go too well because I was only recruiting gnomes and halflings. We were called the Purple Cloaks, but everybody used to call us the Short Swords. It's quite embarrassing. So now I am on a personal mission to find the biggest and baddest creature I can find and kill it. To prove that a gnome can do anything anybody else can do, just as well.
What happens when you become the biggest, baddest creature?
Then we're all screwed.
Yeah. I shall be the Overlord.
Okay.
Alrighty. So it's down to the ladies, I believe. Have we had Geraldine? We had Geraldine. No.
Not really.
No. Oh no, we had a little bit of banter from Geraldine before we actually got to the introductions proper. So go on then, Geraldine. Who are you? And what do you want from life?
Well, stand up at the end of the table, push my chair tidily in, arrange my cloak. I am Geraldine of Sunhollow. You may call me Miss Geraldine. I was ejected from my father's house for not being of his blood. And I thought, well, but since my father was the bishop of Damaran Town, I thought I'd spread the word, gain his favour out in the world, and spread the good word of El Marta, my great god of endurance. And this, shing, is my sword, True Grit, with which I will fight for the law and for the good and for the gods. Clang on the table. Sit down.
I'm a flagon.
Me beer.
That's me.
Marvellous.
Thank you.
So there we have Geraldine the Paladin, and now we leave it to the elephant in the room, I suppose, as the wood elf pointed out. It's time to introduce the draw.
I am a dark elf called Gwenllian, and I know I'm not the most loved creature in the realm, but I'm different because I've left my fellow drow. Because my mentor, who I had a lot of respect for and liked very much, has been kidnapped. And I don't know who he's been kidnapped by. And they refuse to help, so I've left them to go on my own way. And to try and find them. But I do believe very much in the bonds of friendship. But I do like to swindle people now and then if I don't like them very much. But yeah, that's pretty much me. Oh, and I'm a bit sensitive to sunlight. So squint a lot. Like this.
So, to sum up, the main difference between you and the rest of your race is that you aren't a sociopath.
No, I'm not.
Not overtly.
Not a bad sociopath.
You say that.
That's the main problem I have with Drow. The whole...
You haven't yet joined us.
Oh, you like me.
No, I can get behind that not liking sunlight thing, because like, if I don't have to go out, I'm not going out.
Alright,
so, yes, one way or another, you have bonded together in a certain way, whether it be chaotic or tenuous alliances between certain members of the party, through a sort of fortuitous happenstance. The ship known as Timora's Kith was delivering ale, cider, and livestock to Windstone, to the port in which you were drinking, which is Longwang.
City!
I'd just like to point out that Windstone was a campaign setting for 3.5 that I used, and it never really came to fruition. So, stealing everything that I wrote for that, for your background. So you spoke to the captain. You, rather than joining the crew, so to speak, you have quite comfortable guest accommodation aboard Timora's Kith. You're about 4 days' journey from the port Raven's Landing on the Verash continent. However, the captain has said that they need to stop off at Gold Apple Island to pick up some cider for the mainland. And just to plunk you where you should be, the introductory tavern. And for this, I will bring up the map for the people watching. There you go.
I like the idea that every combat, we all have disadvantages because we're all drunk. Like, we start a fight with just some other gang of people.
Bar fight!
We start a fight with a tree.
So, yes, here you are on the second day of your voyage.
Oh god, where are we?
You are in the right, on the right hand side of the map.
Got it.
You should be able to see if you have any issues with the dynamic lighting layer.
Aha!
Let
there
me
we are.
Know. But what we shall do, you're free to roam the ship as you desire. Talk to anyone you encounter. You've kept yourselves to yourselves, talking about, you know, what sort of great adventures you're going to go on when you reach the mainland. And what you know from the captain is that the Gold Apple Island has amazing cider. So I imagine that a few of you will be looking forward to visiting that island. Perhaps not the monk. So if you want to explore, ask what you see. Obviously, as always, don't take everything. If you want to know what you see in some way, just ask and I shall inform you.
Can I start the voyage off on the bow? Just Celine Dion it?
Oh,
yes!
Oh, no. Only if you sing it.
Can I hold you as well doing it?
I withdraw my request. I don't want to sing it.
Negative 500 XP.
Instead, I'll just stand with one leg up on the bow, just shredding it as we leave the port.
Oh, nice, nice. So you are technically the bow spirit for the beginning of the journey.
Yeah, kind of made a rub from my own back there.
Oh, you absolute ass. I knew he was going to do that to me. It's just not fair. It should be. Yes, there we go. It'll allow me to do it as DM. There we go. So there's Lisummer on the bow spirit being all cool and him. Oh, bowsprit. My apologies. My apple bogies. Come.
Bogies. So, oh God. So, what cargo are we carrying again?
So the cargo that remained. No, you're not carrying the cider yet. You're heading towards Gold Apple Island.
Oh yeah.
At the moment, the cargo is empty, save for a rather large crate that's about. 20 foot by 20 foot cube.
Hmm. Ooh. What's in the crate?
To the back.
I check for a hole.
Whoa, it's not that sort of crate.
There are several holes in the crate.
Let's take a peek inside. May as well.
Can I ask the crate a question?
Dude, you can't go around destroying people's stuff, especially when we haven't reached our destination yet. At least let us make port first.
Can I ask a question later?
Are any of the holes in the crate particularly glorious?
Oh no. Well, I suppose the paladin would know, being holy and such.
Oh.
And we've started already.
Indeed.
Oh dear, 10 coppers in the jar, sorry.
So, there's several holes, sort of equally positioned and exactly the same size. There's four on each side of the crate. Not enough light is getting through the holes for you to be able to see, but you can...
dark vision, surely?
Oh, dark vision, is it? Oh, we're playing a card now,
I didn't want to agree with the owl, seeing that I now actually have dark vision in this campaign.
Oh, yes, of course, you can notice some dark vision as well, didn't you?
Yeah.
As they're quite small holes, but feel free to make an investigation.
But here's a problem.
Oh.
These look like breathing holes, and I don't want to put my eye next to the hole there.
Do they smell like breathing holes?
Ooh, that was a good one.
Yeah, that was a good investigation.
Ooh! Oh, I love these animations.
Mine, not so much.
It dice.
So, yeah, Gwenllian. You managed to get a peek through. You see a creature covered in fur.
Oh, few seconds.
It's dormant. It's lying asleep, it was here at the moment. But you can see it's... rising and falling quite softly. The smell of sort of wet dog fills your nostrils as you get closer to the hole.
I will step back.
Guys, you get all that. There's a creature in there. Looks pretty sound at the moment, but it could. Looks like it could possibly wake up.
Okey-dokey. Can I do the logical thing then and come and wake one of these sailors up and ask him what's in the crate?
And I do the logical thing and shake the box violently. I'm kidding.
Who are you?
The love of God. The love of God.
Oh, you know what? I am the chaotic one, so I will actually run up and shake the box and then.
Oh, away. I just put an idea on his head.
That's good, guys. Are you shaking the box, hitting the box? What are we doing here?
Anything cruel to its creature.
Make a strength check for me.
Bet you can't.
2 seconds. Strength check.
Yeah.
All right. So you give the box a good sort of heave and shake it. You hear a slow rumbling growl, something like.
Well, I'm definitely stepping back.
That's interesting.
Okie dokie. I still want to ask these sailors.
What sailors would that be?
Well, I assume they're sailors, or people at least.
So you've stepped into the quarters, as it were.
And I didn't knock, which is terribly rude of me. I do apologise.
These particular sailors are sound asleep in their hammocks. However, the one closest to the door sort of glazed eye looks over at you and goes, "Eh?" They must have been working the night shift.
Sorry to disturb you, friend. I was just wondering what was in the box.
I don't know. We just loaded on and loaded off, mate. Bugger off and let me sleep. I'm the captain. I don't care.
All right. Get back into bed, you maggoty git.
Why have I got that spell?
Okay. I'm done talking to sailors.
Well, you don't know the lingo, you see. You're a landlubber, you see. You don't know the lingo you have to use.
It's true, it's true, it's true.
Do you want to go, Charlie?
No, because he's asleep. I don't want to bother him. I'm not a dick.
Coming from the alcoholic monk.
Yeah.
In recovery.
Like I've got a little card here. Let's see, AAA. No, wait, AA.
All right. So, Raif, you've asked the crew. Axunath, you've shaken and quite possibly woken something up in the cargo area. Taron, would you like to go anywhere, do anything, investigate anything?
What's through this door?
Through that door. If you would like to go through the door, you are more than welcome.
Like, alright, so it's not like somebody's room, is it?
No, so what you see in that room is the eating area, so to speak. There's a table laid out, and stools and large runs of benches.
It's called
very cramped. Yes, I know. I did have everything on information points, but Roll20 seems to have deleted them. I know, it's spontaneity, because all my information points of what's actually in the rooms been deleted. But yeah, so you're in the mess hall, which, if you could call it a hall, it's really not. It's very cramped, can fit. Probably 6 people sat pretty much on each other's laps when they scoffed down their grub.
How big is this boat, like, what type of... Like, what type of crew size am I picturing here?
Crew size is normally 6 on hand per sort of shift. Although, on a good day with a little chop, it can be easily crewed by three or four.
So what you're saying is we could steal the boat if we wanted to.
That would be wrong, but yes.
We did have two sailors.
We did.
We got two sailors. I got the ox.
What do you need?
May I go up to the deck, please?
You may.
We're not robbing a boat, all right?
So, Rafe's going up to the main deck. So you come up there.
It dookie dookie.
Oh, that's a clue. There's another way up.
I'm going to find the captain. Because I'm doing the logical thing. I'm going to ask the captain what's in the crate.
Indeed. Ask the crew. While you're on your way to the captain, Taron.
What is this?
As you enter that room, which is behind a steel-banded door with a lock. It's unlocked. You're having a little poke about, and you jiggle the lock, and it opens up. As you enter that room, you see a series of five cells. So you're in the brig of the ship, and in the sort of cell on the far west, is a semi-naked old man with a scraggly white beard, who looks a little, I might add, like... Oops, come on!
That's a bit strange.
Come on! Why? There we go. Looks a little bit like that.
Hey!
Is that Conan?
Yeah.
Conan the Barbarian.
Conan the Barbarian. Looks, that was the closest approximation I could get to the mind's eye character that I had. And I didn't really want to draw one. So I was like, Conan, that'll do!
Oh. That's a bit. Like, how long have you been at sea? Like, we got on this boat last night, yeah?
Yes, you did.
So why the heck is he in here?
So he's sat there, sort of, playing with his loincloth. Not underneath. he's just sort of twiddling the edges of his loincloth and chuckling to himself. I'm gonna go and tell
everyone.
It's an elf!
Ah, it's a human.
Are you him? I know exactly who you are. I'll tell them. I'll let your secret out, you know.
Really? Why don't you tell me my secret?
I know exactly who you are. You're trying to take over the world. No!
That's a new one.
Don't you play daft with me. I know exactly your plans. I won't let you do it, I tell you, I won't!
Okay. Why? Do you want to play a game of cards?
Cards? Cards? Don't you try and trick me with cards! I'll have you, you know. I know your secret.
Right.
Imposter! Quickly! Guard! Imposter!
I'm just gonna... Just gonna kind of close out that door.
There is a reason why he's labelled crazy old man.
So, as you start exiting the brig, one of the sailors sort of sticks his head out of the door, still looking quite tired, and says, "Oh, don't go near him. Yeah, he's a pain in the ass. I can't wait till we get into the mainland."
What did you? Where did you get him? If you don't mind me asking.
He had a bounty on him. The captain's collecting.
Oh.
Something to do with mad prophecies or magic or something like that. I don't know. I don't pay
attention.
He doesn't
look like a fighter, does he?
He could be. Like, neither did Cohen, but he kicked ass. Alright, so, crazy old prophecies.
What?
Alright, that's... Yeah, he seemed mad.
He seemed pretty crazy. Go on here, back here.
Maybe he's seen things that they shouldn't have seen.
Axe over the sound of the waves from reverberating through the hold. You probably wouldn't have heard from where you are. However, you might have been able to just sort of hear crazy gibbering and high pitched.
Well, I hope he's wrong.
He's just talking rubbish. He's had too much ale in his life, I think. Sod it, I don't care. As long as the captain pays, that's when he gets paid the bounty. That's all I care about, mate.
I'm going to pull out my little acorn necklace and just kind of... What's the word for when you take out a trinket and you kind of like...
Fondle it?
Fondle it, that's not quite the right word, but sort of like... To reassure yourself about something.
Oh, right.
Yeah, touchstone or something.
Kind of like the totem.
What is it?
It's just a little wooden acorn I carved from back home.
A what? Sorry?
Are you doing the Inception thing, making sure you're not in the dream?
It's just, I got this from back home. It was whenever one of my kin is born, we plant a tree.
Oh, an acorn.
Yeah.
And so this is like one of the acorns, and it's just to remind me about where I came from.
Yeah, I like it.
Interesting.
And so I carved this from some of it as well.
But it's not a real acorn.
No.
All right, so the crewman goes, all right, I'll see you later.
All right.
Do me a favour, don't go prodding him or anything. He's armless in there.
Mad, sir.
As Raif has... I see Lisummer's there also.
Yeah.
My apologies, I forgot about your Celine Dion moment up on the main deck.
That's okay.
Raif and Lisummer, what we'll do is you enter at the same time and sat at the captain's table. You see a gnome who Raif you recognise as your Uncle Heck.
What a twist.
And he says, young Raif, how are you, my boy?
Very well, Uncle Heck. Very good to see you.
And you were a bit worse for wear when we took you on board. Been drinking again.
Not gonna lie, Uncle Heck. Yes.
You want to give it up, you know. It's good for keeping the gout away, but that's about it.
Well, there's not much else to do when you're a sellsword who nobody wants to pay.
And, well, you know, there's opportunities abound, I tell you. Oh, one moment. So as he starts blistering about, he reaches under his desk and you hear a trickling of fluid, and then a quick that's better. Right, so what can we do for you?
Couple of questions.
Yes.
Good old Uncle Heck. Never lied to me in your life, Uncle Heck.
Well, maybe once or twice when you were a nipper, but what?
Yes, two things. One, you seem to be drinking yourself.
It's just a bit of the old private reserve, you know, keep the gout away.
I'm not quite sure that's how it works, but then again, you know, I'm not a druid, so I wouldn't know. And two, you have a rather large box downstairs in the hall.
Ah, yes. Little something we picked up at Windstone, you know. Rather important. Someone requested that we
Yes.
What's in the box, Uncle Head?
Ah! Ah! No, my lad. If I told you, I would probably get in a lot of trouble with the Viscount.
It's fine, Uncle Heck. You can tell me. I won't say anything. And Lisummer is—he's only a bard. He wouldn't tell a soul.
Very rarely.
A bard.
Things that I hear.
Well, here, let me ask you something now, young bard, my man. Have you ever heard the tale of Sharksbane?
I can't say that I have.
Ah.
Do furnish me with such a tale.
Well, there's a tale travelling the seas and the taverns of ports about a heroic captain who fights off sharks with his bare hands, you know.
Can I strum him along as he's telling me this?
Yep, of course, feel free. You can
sort
of
it,
He sails the high seas, looking for a payday, I suppose. But no, he fights off great whites with his bare hands, don't you know? And he leans under his desk, and you hear the. That's better.
A guy suffers from a lot of gout.
Keep it at bay. A flag and a day, you know, and all that. But if such a tale should start to be told across the realms, then then I wouldn't object, you know.
Yeah, I think I might actually make a note of that.
So,
whether it be true or not.
Oh! I can vouch, you know. I've heard, I've seen it. I've seen it, you know. Impressive display.
I just want to turn to the listener and go. Have you ever known a gnome to lie?
That sounds fairly lyrical as well. I think I'll write that one down. Known a gnome to lie? No.
We're not known for our lying. Little pranks maybe, but never lying.
One could say you're not gnome for your lying. I'll be jumping off the ship now.
But why? You've just got bonus XP.
Huzzah.
He's kind of being a bit deflective on the questions of the box.
Uncle Heck, you still haven't answered the question.
Haven't I? What was that? I'll be right there. Excuse me, my lad. I think the person's calling me.
what would my grandfather say if they had known you were...
Now, my lad. You know I have a lot of love for your mother. and your father. They're wonderful, wonderful, wonderful gnomes. Wouldn't say a bad word against your father. What was your name, my lad? As he points to Lisummer.
My name is Lisummer Burrowsfeet.
Lisummer Burrowsfeet, right. Be a good lad, would you? Go and see the cook. Go and see old cook downstairs. Ask her to whip up a good old meal for you and your friends.
Okay, I kind of narrow my eyes. Like, not really my job, but okay, fair enough. I'll go with it.
I just turn and nod and sort of.
Yeah. I strum gayfully as I walk down the corridor.
Man.
Singing his new tune. Have you ever known a gnome to lie?
Have you ever known a gnome to lie? Have you ever asked him the reason why?
Oh, so, this is getting very lyrical.
Yeah.
I'll work on that.
Barding it up. I like it.
Find it out.
So, Hex sort of looks at the door, and as it clicks closed, as Lisummer trots away, he sort of puts his arm over your Raif, and you get the seriously strong smell of rum and body odor, and a sort of faint smell of cheddar. It's the only way I can really describe the smell coming from good old Uncle Heck. And he says, now listen here, my boy. What I'm about to tell you is absolutely tip-top secret. You understand?
Of course, Uncle Heck.
Now, you mustn't tell us so. I must make this absolute... Can't tell anyone.
I wouldn't even tell my mother, Uncle Heck.
Oh, you're a good
lad. I tell my mother everything.
Yeah, I'm glad she doesn't tell you everything. she was over there. So he sort of pats you on the back and says, now look, the Viscount at Raven's Landing, you see, wanted us to collect something from that idiot. What's his name? The Pratt at Newstone. Ow! Horrible fat human thing. Yep.
Lord Boris.
That's the one. That stupid bastard. Never mind. I'm getting paid. I tell you what I'll do. I'll give you 100 gold if you keep this under your hat, alright?
I'm not wearing a hat, but I can definitely keep a secret.
That'll do! That'll do! Well, you must be very careful when you go near that box, okay? Because there's a very, very angry thing in there that we were asked to ship to the mainland.
So, what's in the box, Uncle Heck?
It might seem rather tame, for compared to other beasts, but yes. It's a wolf. It's a wolf of a certain variety. Not normally domesticated.
There aren't many wolves that are domesticated, Uncle Heck. You have to be a bit more specific.
Now, look here. I can't say any more than that, I'm afraid.
So basically, what you're saying is it's a big-ass wolf that's probably quite vicious and probably should be a bigger, more stronger box.
Now, I have total faith. They're not big fans of the wall, you see. So they sort of go quite docile. So I'm hoping it'll stay that way for the duration of the trip.
Yeah, there might be an issue with that, Uncle Heck, because the barbarian got a bit frustrated with not knowing what's in the box.
He did what?
He may or may not have shook it a little bit. He's a big brute, but he means well. He just wanted to know what was in the box.
Oh dear God! that's not good, my boy. That's really not good. We must go and look quickly. Move, my boy, move.
Wait. Just clarify something. I get the 100 gold now, or I get the 100 gold later?
Just move, boy! See, he's sort of trying to rush past you, thinking, oh, crap!
Isn't there stairs down here?
Yes, there are. This way, my boy! This way, quickly! So, Lisummer... you, as you headed down, you were heading to the galley. My apologies for that little session with. So as you run down the stairs to the lower deck, I would like Lisummer and Raif, and obviously Heck, just for a moment.
Mm-hmm.
And I would like everyone to roll initiative, please.
Aww.
Oh dear.
I'm guessing this was my fault, wasn't it?
Yes.
Jim, while these guys have been upstairs fighting with the captain, do I actually have these cantrips that are described on my character sheet, or are they wrong?
What? I haven't put anything on your sheet.
No, quite exactly. I thought they were wrong.
Hey, what?
Why would you have cantrips?
I have no idea why I would have cantrips.
It'd be interesting.
Oh my god, Roll 20 have updated something.
Ha!
I'm really gutted that that chat was not added to the stream. Because we were sitting there playing cards and everything and having a whole role session going on.
Yeah, we were doing a lot of stuff.
Good god!
Yeah, well, it's a waste my way to go.
Dear Lord! cantrip-wise, do paladins not have cantrips?
I didn't think they did. I only get level 1s.
I don't think so.
Bless your wounds under a smite. That sounds about right. And speak with animals.
That's what I thought. That would be really useful right now.
How have you... What?
Somebody's druidified me.
Something's definitely updated on 120, because they didn't look like that before anyway.
Mm. Wait a minute.
My character sheet's totally different.
Say again?
No. Thank you.
What oath did you take, Oath of the Ancients?
Yes.
You got to speak with animals as a spell. As a third level spell. You also get ensnaring strike. With animals.
Speak with animals something else. Which it didn't put the name in for. I assume it's blessed because the effects are all blessy.
I can speak with animals, but they got to be small, so I don't think it's going to be any use in this situation.
Go on.
So I think the paladin, if she can speak to animals, would be very, very useful.
Yeah.
It depends if this is an animal or not. Or just something that
is. It's furry and it's growly, I think it's an animal.
You would assume it's an animal, yeah. Unless you have nature.
Nope.
You could roll a nature check.
It could be a shifter.
Yeah, something like that.
That would be scary.
I like shifters.
You could roll a nature check and see if, Oh, yeah.
So while they're having this discussion upstairs, you're trying to ascertain what exactly has just woken up and is growling a little bit inside the box, correct?
Mm-hmm. Correct.
With an 11, you can discern that this hairy beast is more than likely a wolf. And it sounds quite large.
Oh, large wolf. Alrighty.
I know why he chose wolf.
Right then. Please have a batter at booking with the wolf.
Yeah, you can do. I'm not quite sure on the intelligence level of wolves, if I'm honest, because it's dependent. They speak with animals is dependent on their hooting flip. Do me a favour, just give me the rundown on the description of speak with animals.
Hang on. It says gain the ability to comprehend and verbally communicate with beasts for the duration 10 minutes. The knowledge and awareness of many beasts is limited by their intelligence, but at minimum, beasts can... Hold on, it misses out a paragraph. Wait a sec, let's bring up the proper one. Beasts can give you information about nearby locations and monsters, including whatever they perceive or have perceived within the past day. You may be able to persuade a beast to perform a small favour for you at the DM's discretion.
Okie dokie. Alright, that's cool.
All
right. So what are you trying to communicate with the beastie in the box?
With the creature. Oh, I'll just say, hello, are you alright?
So, you hear a sniffing at the holes that are closest to you.
Mm-hmm.
And you are able to comprehend that the wolf, in a very growly sort of way, is, says... sorry, what was the question?
How are you, was it?
How are you? Oh, yes.
I was fine until I was woken up.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you know where you are?
Dark. Warm. Don't like it.
Have you been fed?
No.
All right. Do you know where you're going?
No.
Were they mean to you? Boy.
I'm in a box. It's dark. It's warm.
So all the while, Gwenllian and Taron, unless you have comprehend animals, I don't know, all you're hearing is and Geraldine sort of just talking to the box.
Alright. Well, be calm and please don't hurt anybody. And we'll do what we can with you. Back later!
Make a persuasion check!
Oh my goodness!
Is it, oh, hang on, we're 5th edition. Is it persuasion? Or is it...
Yeah.
is it just diplomacy.
Diplomacy.
No, it is persuasion. That is, you correct.
Your choice, persuasion or diplomacy.
Persuasion!
There is no diplomacy.
Who said diplomacy?
Also 4th edition. persuasion.
So, as you attempt to placate the creature in the box, you hear a series of rather large and rather clawy bangs on the side of the box, and it shifts slightly towards you.
Is that good?
You make a perception check or an insight. But
all right. I'm not terribly smart. Here we go.
Yeah, that's bad.
You get the feeling that everything is fine.
Fine. Oh my god.
Which, as we all know, when the DM says you get the feeling everything is fine,
it's not.
As a wood cover, do I think this box is structurally sound?
Oh! A wood covering. Ooh, fancy.
Alright, I just have one more question for the Wolfie. What are you and where did you come from? That's two questions. But...
I am from the cold north.
Alright.
It's a direwolf.
Wood Calvary, Wood Elfie Chappie.
Yeah.
You're trying to ascertain whether the box is suitable for whatever may be inside.
Well, I saw it just knock the box about a bit, so I'm kind of going, yeah.
Alrighty. So from the sound of the thud, that's pretty much all you're going on at the moment.
Well, I did look at the box earlier,
oh,
no, but
yeah. Sorry, yes, you did look in the box, and you saw it was fluffy.
Well, no, I mean, I was also looking at the box when I was doing it, obviously, so... I did have a close look at it.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just trying to think what sort of check you could make on that. Perception.
Knowledge? Is there such a thing?
Well, you could just do, an attribute plus proficiency bonus. But yeah, I'm happy with perception because that's the same thing for me. But
yeah, rock on. Go perception. Ooh, yes. You can ascertain that a few more strikes with that sort of rusty, and the box will not hold.
I kind of say, Geraldine, get away.
It's all right, it's just a dog.
Is it? Where would a dog be in a rock?
As far as Geraldine knows.
I think he's just hungry.
I kind of, like, look to, who else is down here at the moment? Just Gwenllian and...
At the moment, because this is sort of happening as the conversation upstairs is going on with Heck and Raif. You've got Gwenllian, Taron, and Geraldine. And Axunath is standing.
I'm standing
at the back saying, get the fuck away!
I kind of shrug and I stand up and I kind of go, what? Do you know what it is?
It's hungry.
Is it time to stab anything yet?
Let me just roll a d20.
It is a point, like, if it was in there, assumedly they need to feed it or die, I guess.
I don't think he's been fed.
How big are these holes? Can you fit food through it?
They are quite small. They're literally around about 2 inches around.
And how long is this boat trip meant to take?
I think it's 4 days to the mainland. 5 days to the mainland.
He's going to get annoyed.
Alright, so that's strange. Because they put a live creature in a box, assuming they transport it, but without any clear way of feeding it.
Mm-hmm. They're not really trappers, they're more sailors, so they're just thinking about the payday, they're not thinking about the cargo so much.
Captain Heck likes to define him and his crew as mercenaries.
Mercenaries? Bless him.
The thing is, well, I'm just kind of... There's a lot of weird stuff here, and I'm kind of worried. So I'm just kind of... I'm getting ready to, like, in case things go... What's the equivalent of south? East?
In case things go east. So...
Racist.
at this point... A very large crash against the side of the crate sends splinters of wood flying off towards, in Geraldine's direction, and none of them hit you, I'm afraid.
Splinters of wood.
Splinters of wood dart out from the box and... Come on. Yep, there we go.
Well, you're all wearing armor, so...
I am.
Splinters isn't really...
And so does rather large wolf that... I would like you to make a dex check, please, Geraldine.
Certainly.
Nice.
And you... successfully dodge out of the way of this flying wolf that looks very, very angry. What I would like to point out at this moment in time is that what has just darted out of the box is a large wolf with pure white fur and sort of almost glowing blue eyes.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Like, as it eats you, it's like, oh, you're so pretty. Yeah, you're so pretty.
You're so pretty.
So pretty.
As it eats your leg.
His teeth are inches from a juggler.
And so, I would like to throw it to Raif, who at this moment in time, you have just reached the foot of the stairs from the main deck, along with Heck Sharksbane. And also, Lisummer, you were sent off, I'm sorry. So you are in the galley, which isn't working because of the bloody dynamic lighting there! Sorry, I'm going to the DM side of it. There we go. So you are currently in this room, which is probably pitch black for you right now.
Cool.
I'm not quite sure. It shouldn't be. There's a
Oh no, it's fine. Yeah, everything's inside it now.
Yep, cool. So you hear the crash. Axonath, you see the crash. You see the flying splinters and the darting Geraldine. And Raif, you are first to go.
Excellent. Where is he?
He's down to the south.
Oh yeah, there we are.
So you hear a large crash and the sound of a darting paladin.
Clang.
Well, obviously I'm going to move to investigate. Five, and that's as far as I can get because I only have a movement of 25 feet because I've only got little legs. I only have little legs.
Aww.
You're like a baby.
In fact, I'm going to move to that one to get a line of sight. Could I actually throw a javelin from here without hitting Geraldine?
That would be down to the dice. Because you are quite a stout little creature, and Geraldine is quite big.
Not that big.
So what does he throw through her legs? That's how I did it.
Not this again.
I didn't do it with a javelin, admittedly, but still.
Javelins, it would take some considerable skill.
You might...
I'm just going to have to move up here and that's going to be it, because I can't get line of sight or anything, and I'm not going to attempt it on the first attack roll of the new game.
And then end up don't forget, the roll that you have now determines your fate for the rest of the campaign. This is lucky or unlucky roll.
I did so well on the initiative, I kind of don't want to tempt anything, so I'm just going to leave it there for now and just sort of stand back and assess the situation.
So you don't hit the paladin in the back with a javelin.
I'm going to go, oh shit, that wolf is bigger than the paladin.
Oh, it's much bigger. Oh, Axonath! It's time.
How far is my movement?
You should be 30, you're a human.
I thought he was a little person as well.
No, I'm barbarian.
Oh, no,
that's too far away.
Don't you have, like, don't barbarians get a movement speed boost? You might have more.
That's not actually, what's the attack range on a javelin?
Oh, yeah.
30 feet.
So if I move up, I can land to my own.
Yeah.
Right, if roll 20 something should be for me, that'd be great.
From where you are, there is still the shipping crate the wolf was in, so for you, it would be considered in cover.
Hmm.
Could I not move? Can you see my...
Yep. That's cool.
Can I move to there and then see if we'd be able to hit the wolf
yep,
in there?
Yep, that's cool. That's fine.
It might still be a bit tricky, but yeah.
Yeah, I like tricky, it's fun.
Alright, so just to sort of spell out what's in the area, all there is at the moment is the crate and the wolf. Are just decoration on the...
I would like to attack it with a javelin, because I don't like ignoring on my friends.
Mm-hmm.
Near friends. I'm not sure if it's friends.
Javelins are cool.
Let's see what happens. Choose a target. What kind of tokens we should?
I'm just like, you will come to watch.
You
yes.
Get it off!
Did anybody bring popcorn?
Did anybody invent popcorn?
Yeah, it's coming up with choose target, target. Click a token on the screen to choose a target. I have to be selected to do this now?
What? You set up a macro, have you?
No! Oh, I'm doing it through the standard sheet thing.
Yes.
Oh, they've changed the target, have they? Ooh!
Yeah.
When did they do this update? I didn't get an email!
Well, I can't select the wall to do it.
Are you sure it's that?
If I select myself and then try you, it still does the same thing.
Hang on a
minute. I see what you mean. That's dumb.
Yeah, it's weird, isn't it?
This should be why they do that without the token nonsense.
People took it off for the love of God. Why did they do this? Why? Simply why? Why did they do
Wait a minute. Maybe there's a settings option or something.
No, I've got a horrible, horrible feeling that they did this as part of an update. But.
We should have probably checked for just in case.
Well, no, I normally get in because of my subscriber level. I get nice emails saying what they've updated, but I've never seen this before.
Yeah, a nice change log would be great, wouldn't it?
Well, this is good.
Great start to the action.
Oh, yeah. Jesus Christ. It might be because it's occupying the same square as Geraldine. Let's have a problem check. Nope, it's just being it. Oh, no, hang on. No attributes found for the target. What? Oh, for the love of God.
Okay, so here's what you're going to do. You see where it says what you have to hit?
It's just,
well, that kind of defeats the purpose of actually using the tabletop when it doesn't sodding work.
Yeah, but you know, it's either that or we watch you fiddle around for half an hour.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to be the force of reason here, but we might have to suck it up and be lame.
Right.
I don't know what I have to roll for javelins because I've never used these weapons at all.
Javelins is a d6.
Just one d6.
Well, you have to ward a hit.
Plus your strength modifier if you're using strength, or dex modifier if you're using dex.
So ward a d20 plus proficiency plus your strength.
Yeah.
Which should be like...
And then just a d6 for damage.
Right, can someone explain that to me now?
Oh god.
Right, your javelin, just roll... A d20 plus 5, that'll be your javelin.
Well, that's... You missed. Like, you missed. What do you want? There's no way in hell you hit.
That's a 7.
That wasn't the plus.
It doesn't matter. You definitely...
I don't know how it works.
No, the other one didn't have the plus 5 on it anyway. I was just... Good. Yeah, it's just... I don't know why that's American.
It's been...
Yeah, still missed anyway.
Yep, you missed. Gwenllian! Over to you.
Well, there's still a lot of skill checks to work at least. It's just the weapons.
Yeah, I'm just double-checking that it's not... any of the, you know, the damage API or anything like that. It's,
So, sorry, because I missed
a
bit.
There's a bloody great wolf just jumped out of a box in the cargo hold,
right.
Which is the art. And that's all that's in the room other than you, is a large box that's just been broken out of by the wolf that is currently, that's just pounced at Geraldine.
Okay. Sure. Did you say you're having a problem with your weapons throws? Or...
Oh my god, they have when did they change that? Hey, I never mind. Right. Let me just double check because I've just disabled the API stuff. Which should have. Oh no, it's nothing to do with the API.
Okay.
Oh great.
I'm Googling it at the moment, but I'm not getting much.
Yeah. Have a look on the roll for any support. So, whatever it says, your dice plus your who do you fit on the old doobie who do you what's it? That's the doobie doobie. Really?
Okay, so if I do an attack roll from my character sheet, is it going to work?
No, because it'll ask you to target something. You'll have to roll what the actual dice says.
Oh, wait, I figured out how to do it.
Hang on, there we go.
How to do it?
Here's what you do. Go to the little wrench thing.
The what?
Yeah.
the little wrench thing in your settings.
Icon, yeah.
You know,
right.
Turn off the show targets AC on attacks. Turn that off.
What the hell is that?
That should be... It should be below the initial role thing. You see, like, it has the core stats, background, class, weapons, armor, spellbook, infantry.
Oh, in the character sheet.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So you turn that off for each character. So it says you do not show the target's AC and attacks, which means you don't have to target the stupid thing anymore.
Let me just check that as well.
And then you have to fill in the crit damage on your character sheet as well. You also have to fill in the crit damage.
Right. Gwenllian, I will do that for you now.
Oh, thank you.
And now everything's working for me.
If
everyone
else does...
I'm just checking my...
That is absolutely ridiculous.
Sweet! Good luck.
That was lucky.
Good man.
I looked at this thing. That's what I got it from. I didn't just pull the information out of
my head. No, it's all good.
I was looking at the forge myself.
Oh wait, where the hell is the... Wait. There you go, Gwenllian, you are good to roll.
Yay!
It means I can turn on all my APS IPI stuff again.
Buddy, roll 20! But I hate you!
Going to attack this beast then. Oh, is that a hit?
That is unfortunately not a hit.
Move back a little bit.
Shuffy, shuffy, shuffy. And Lisummer, you're currently just about to enter the galley. Here you are when all this is happening. What would you like to do? Oh, no, wait, hang on.
So I'm in the galley.
What's going on with my bloody initiative order on there? No, not Geraldine, Lisummer! Thank you.
Cool. So I'm in the galley at the moment. I gather I hear some ruckus from outside.
You hear a large crash.
Okay, a couple of questions. My movement speed is 25. Does that have to be just regular walking, or can it be start off with a jog and then end with a power slide on your knees?
Yes, of course you can.
Well, you can drop phone as a free action, so I don't see why not.
Yes, screw it. Yeah, that'll do.
In that case, I would like to turn about face in the gallery when I hear this kicking off. Kick the door in as a bonus action, and then run and slide on my knees whilst producing my loot, and just strum one power chord on it, and sing, sleep! And I'll sleep.
Bard feature. As a bonus action, you can be awesome.
So we... And then watch me completely fail this.
What are you even doing?
Casting sleep on the...
Rather dramatically casting sleep.
Yes. There's any way to go with a bard, just dramatic everything. I just need to roll 5d8, and that's its amount of hit points. So,
the roll... It has to be strength save.
I knew I should have checked the bard spell sheets to make sure they were filled in.
So what's this versus what sleep versus?
It's actually just 5d8 hit points. That's it affects.
Imagine the constitution, isn't it?
And it is sleep.
So it's
so that does. It's just if it has if I roll 5d8 and if it has that amount of hit points or less, it just goes to sleep.
There's all no right, sleep. Okay. No, I'm with you. That's cool.
Wait, here's a problem.
Yeah.
It doesn't. This is a general. It starts. You can't target it. There's a 5-year chance you could send one of us to sleep. In fact,
he's already cast it now and rolled it out. Come on.
Crit creatures within 20 feet of the point you choose within range.
Yeah, creatures.
Oh, heck.
But it starts with that creature. It starts with them, maybe some other people might fall asleep as well. But that's fine. I wouldn't worry about that.
With the ascending order of the...
Are you kidding me?
Now this is how you play a bard!
Quick question, how do I roll 5d8? Is it just 4/roll 5d8?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
I'm not saying this is awesome.
16.
But...
Okay, so
16 or less.
We haven't got any squishies.
Does anyone have less than 16 health?
No.
No. Near.
So you play a mighty sort of soothing strum on your lute, and everybody sort of goes, "Oh, that was nice."
What's the bard's health?
The bard is safe.
No, I just
don't forget you started at level 3.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Sure.
That's the point. Is that spell affected by your level?
I didn't put it in the second level slot, so no, it's not affected by level.
All right. However, 10 out of 10 for style.
Yeah, it was awesome.
That's pretty much all bards are. It's all...
you slid in.
Flamboyant and no content.
Yeah.
You slid in, played a lullaby, and then we kind of went, that's nice, but...
Don't
know
that lullaby in this part of the world. Taron.
Alright, I'm going to jump in this box, jump in that box, and jump down and rabbit punch it in the head.
Right, you are.
There isn't a box here.
No. There is just the large box and the wolf.
Really? In that case, I run right around.
Superman punch, man.
Yeah, give me a second. I gotta check my abilities. And I'm gonna spend a key point as well to get some extra attacks. Because I can do that shit. Also, I'm not actually using my fist at the moment. I've pulled out a staff that was on my back. A quarter staff, to be accurate, but anyway. So my
you had a long rod on your back.
Yeah. And in my pants. Right, let me just check that I'm doing this right. Okay, so there's my first normal attack, which might hit.
That hits, yeah.
And then I spend one key point and I make two bonus attacks.
Ooh.
And one of them, well, let me just check that I'm doing this right again, because I think one of them has to be an unarmed strike.
I imagine it does, but...
I think they both have to be unarmed strikes, yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, so that's fine.
Alright.
So I'm just going to give it two good kicks.
I was going to say, as a free action, you can unequip weapons.
Well, I can hold it with one hand and punch with the other, so that's fine. So, force attack.
Yep.
And it must now make a dexterity saving throw or be knocked prone.
Dude.
DC 12, so it's pretty easy DC.
There you go. And it is not knocked prone.
Well, I got one last attack and 6 damage.
Jesus!
So pow, 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 and I'm done.
Nice.
Because I can't move away, and I can't disengage, unfortunately.
Oh, and of course, the egg guy is not going to work now.
So, I've now pissed off the wolf. Yay!
Yeah,
I pissed it off first, at least, come on.
Yep, you woke him up. There we go, it's working.
Aww.
That's the part what they should do, actually.
It's trying to eat you. Don't be sympathetic.
And
poor helpless animal, what did it do to you?
It's not helpless, look at it.
It tried to eat you for a start.
This is a perfectly honourable fight.
And he said mean things about your god.
What?
All of them.
What?
Yeah, every single
how
one.
How the hell would you know? Were you talking to it? No, I don't think you were, actually. That's incorrect. Oh, I'll try and put it out of its misery.
Yep, over to you, Geraldine.
Let's take a swing at this beast. There we are. So yes, I apologise to the wolf, and then slap it.
Sorry, not sorry.
Wait, that's, so yeah. That's nice. Your definition of slap is to stab it with a longsword.
Yep.
Interesting.
It's got to be put out of its misery.
Technically, slash it with a longsword.
I thought that's what the bard did.
That was a long cord.
Ah. Oh. Nice.
Bonus points for you, sir.
I'm going to try.
So, yeah, the wolf seems a little bit more agitated now you've taken swings at it.
I'm sorry.
As it's quite hungry, it's just been woken up quite abruptly in a climate that it's not particularly fond of. It strikes out at Geraldine.
Of course.
And that is, unfortunately, 21 versus your AC.
Ow.
Yeah. Taking that hits.
Is it up above or below? Sorry, I can never get...
Say again?
Come on.
What?
Above or below my AC?
Say again?
Does it have to be above or below my
above.
AC?
Above.
Yes, it is.
Yep, that's it. Right, okay. And he takes a nice chunk out of your indented breastplate. And you take... GG. 11 points of damage.
So, are you feeling sympathetic towards it now?
Yes!
That's impressive, I give you that.
And that's the end of the Wolfie's turn. What's going on with this turn order bloody thing? It's going crazy. Raif!
Well, I'm obviously going to move. Can I move here? Or is that still box?
That's still box. The southern side of the box has been broken open, but the rest remains intact.
Can I get in front of the wolf?
I would probably say at this point.
So there's nowhere
although
I can...
Although you are small.
I was going to say, I really, really want to twat it, but at the moment I'm sort of not in the right place.
It's the halflings, unfortunately, get to move through people, which is kind of... Because, like, gnomes, I imagine, should be about the same size.
Well, yeah, they're small creatures. Do you know what? I'm going to be kind and merciful. Because that's what I'm like.
We know.
Says as he sinks the boat in the next hour.
End up in a lifeboat with the wolf. Wait a minute.
Please don't sink the boat. I want Uncle Heck to leave it with me when he dies.
When he dies of natural causes of being pushed off the boat, you mean?
None of you are going to touch my Uncle Heck. 17.
Oh, that'll do it.
For 6 points of damage.
Nice and nice. Done. Lock. Run. Barbarian! Do your thing.
Oh, God.
Right. I'm guessing it's not possible for me to get there to hit it.
You could jump on the box like a badass.
Yeah, you could jump on top of the box. We won't don't take it as that's the occupied square, because the roof of the box is still intact.
So I can jump on top of the box?
Mm-hmm.
Been, like, get that far.
Yeah.
I will run and jump on top of the box. Well, attempt to.
You jump in, make legs, or acrobatics. No?
Athletics.
Athletics, yeah.
Is there anything he can jump on to give himself advantage or something?
Like, no.
Oh, wow, that sucks. Sorry, dude. It's
just the box, the wolf, and you guys.
What do you want, acrobatics or athletics?
Athletics, please, my boy.
Even better.
Bollocks. Yeah, it's possible. How tall is the box? Like, so what, does his middle bit reach off, and then he kind of slams into it and kind of goes,
Wah. How tall is...
How tall am I?
Yeah.
I've got this written down, and... Oh.
6 foot? Yeah, you make it.
Sweet. can I attack from here with my...
Yep, you can swing downwards.
Sweet. I will swing downwards with the great axe of wounding.
And at this point,
I'm oh, actually Christ.
Going to say,
oh.
I was going to say, and we'll stick to it, be merciful. I did mention last week that we would be using, not necessarily flanking, but helping. And as you are technically above the creature, you have advantage on your attack.
Oh, thank God. Because somebody was going to lose a head there.
Do you know what? I could have done that, but that wouldn't have been fair. I did say we were going to use that that style. So if you attack from behind while the creature is engaged, you get advantage. So, yes, it takes a whopping 15 points of damage, and you a sort of splay of fur goes flying.
Woot.
And that's why you bring a barbarian.
Yeah.
And Gwenllian.
Gonna run over here and show you how it's done, guys.
Well,
or maybe not.
Your dad stuck inside the.
Alright. That could have been worse, because I thought you were going to stab me in the back and everything.
To remove your dagger on your next turn, I will need you to make a strength check.
Okay.
Because you've planted it solidly in the wood. However, Lisummer!
Not one to break tradition. I've got a couple of questions. I don't suppose there's a chandelier in here, is there?
Boat!
Oh, you!
Yeah, it could be a fancy boat, you never know.
Unfortunately not. 30 foot above of the cargo hold.
That's a bit high for me. I don't think I can make that. very well. Can I hop up into these small crates?
They're not there. That's just scene decoration for the boat. It's just the large crate and yourselves and the wolf.
And that's the large crate is 20 feet high, isn't it?
Correct.
I'm not going to be able to scale that. Fair enough. Okay, I'm just going to run around. I'm going to run 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. My next. Can I squeeze in there?
No!
We're
pushing this kind of merciful thing a bit here.
What? He is a halfling, to be fair. He actually.
No, that's cool. That's cool. Halfling.
Yeah.
Well, it says.
Borked on this map.
Yeah. You know, having not, succeeded in playing the loot. I'm gonna sheath it, take out my rapier, and just have at him.
Have at him!
Have at me!
Do you know what? The way that you're portraying your bard, I picture Kermit the Frog from Muppet Treasure Island, where he's fighting Long John Silver.
Exactly. Lunge! What do I get?
Oh, nice! That Goodness. Is most definitely a hit with the Nandaka.
I shall thwart thee, foul wolfie.
He's not foul, he's hungry.
Wolf racist.
Casual wolf racism.
Yeah, that's fine.
Lycanphobia?
Yeah. Taron. Yeah, this is getting kind of cramped, to be honest. I don't think we can claim advantage anymore at this point. It's just...
now it's just a royal clusterfuck.
Maybe.
You should be used to these being a saber.
You had to say that as I was taking a drink.
The royal clusterfuck was the name of the wealthy family that used to.
I never took part in those sort of affairs.
Wise.
No, not willingly, anyway.
Like, I'm a monk, you're not allowed to do that kind of stuff.
Tell me about it.
Anyway, gonna bonk it on the head.
Oh, nice.
And same thing I did last time. Two key point and attack twice.
Bonk.
Yeah, did that hit?
Does that hit? Yep, that hits.
Oh, good.
Lucky bastard.
Make a save. You know, I'm going to try something different.
Oh.
I'm going to make a strength saving throw.
Okay. The wolf's going to make strength here.
Yeah, DC 12. Just for fun.
Fails.
Put 15 feet away.
Fuck!
Wow.
What?
Stumbling through
okay.
the air.
Okay, so he's gone from an OP halfling lightfoot rogue to.
Wait.
Super
as it leaves, I'm gonna give it a weak kick in the ass. Like, no, actually, I probably miss, but.
Yeah, that's
a misinterpret. Well, I'm done, so I just give it a wee kick.
So, it's been punted.
Does it unlock? Does it ricochet?
15 foot, did you say?
Yeah.
Lisummer, Geraldine, Raif, you're safe. Lisummer and Geraldine, please make dexterity saving throws as the large wolf goes flying towards you, catches its hind end on the and Lisummer, your stature saves you. Geraldine, you are knocked prone.
Sorry about that.
You're flat on your back, love.
I kind of move over here and I'm like, hey Gwen, how's up?
I'm dignified.
Bloody hell.
I remember this technique from before.
What, the runaway technique?
Yeah, the runaway technique, yeah.
Yes, and splat it and run away. I see.
Geraldine. Oops, sorry, he's over there now.
I think I'd better get off my arse.
You are currently prone, so your movement is halved.
Well, okay. It takes half your movement to stand up.
Okay.
You've only got to move. And you've only got to move 10 feet anyway.
Yes, yeah, so you're fine, really.
Yeah.
So, I kind of... Oh, yeah. I kind of go, sorry, by the way.
Sorry!
That's 10 copper in the jar!
I didn't swear.
No, you just swearing. Kicked a wolf at her.
To be fair, it was at all of you, to be fair.
How poorly is he? He looks pretty poorly, doesn't he? Thing.
After that dramatic punt, he's looking very much worse for wear.
Right. But I'm not going to get an attack in, am I?
You get 10 foot of movement. Sorry, you get 15 foot of movement. from your stand up, you've got 30 foot correct. So you would be you'd be able to attack.
Oh, just.
All right.
You could make another diplomacy or whatever check. I mean, like, we can kick your ass.
I think it's too late. You lot have beaten it up, and it's not going to listen to me.
Although, thank you for saying something like that, because I've been waiting for some the whole to start the sound.
What?
I see your point.
Try and be nice, offer a chance to surrender.
If only you'd done that last week.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually. You have a fair point there, yeah. So, assuming it's less than 10 minutes since I started speaking with animals.
let me have a quick think on the time it's taken.
It should be.
Yeah, because you were talking with it, you were conversing with it.
And then they dove in on it.
Yep, that's cool.
Okay, so I will try and persuade it to surrender. Wolf, you're wounded. I could slay you with one blow in the next second. Would you like to desist from your attacks, and we will leave you be. Please, Mr. Wolf.
'Tis but a scratch.
Yeah.
Hungry.
Food? I did ask someone earlier if they had a sandwich.
I do have food if you need.
I kind of yell over, just kill the damn thing.
Yes.
I'm okay with that.
Kill the bitch.
I'm okay with that.
So now, are you still conversing with it?
Okay. It's just hungry.
It's hungry, and you've just beaten the shit out of it. It's very, very, very.
I didn't beat the shit out of it.
I'm sorry. Let me just scroll up a second here.
Only four.
Oh yes, you gave it a little love tap with 15 exactly. Slashing damage. Oh no, sorry, that was X.
Eight.
Wasn't me.
That was four, but you did give it a good slashing. So he's a bit.
Wait a minute. I did four. Four slashing damage.
You hit it!
It's like, you don't get to hit someone and go, oh, I'm your friend.
Oh, I'm sorry! Awfully sorry.
Alright. Does he surrender? Do you surrender? Go back in your box. Back in the box.
I will feast on you.
I'll bet you will.
And now it's the wolf's turn.
Very well.
Go figure. This is what you get for playing a bleeding heart.
Almost further goaded by Geraldine's attempt to parley with the pissed off wolf. It exhales. A very deep breath, and
Oh gosh!
And I this one.
Oh!
Whoa!
I made the right move, didn't I?
Lisummer and Geraldine, please make dexterity saving throws now.
Glad I moved.
Dexterity, yes, please.
Bollocks.
Oh dear.
Okie dokie.
You probably failed, not gonna lie.
I have enjoyed this
Christ. You take a severe blast of cold damage.
Cold?
No, Geraldine made it. She might have made it.
And Axonath, you also take a severe blast of ice cold breath. And Geraldine, you don't take as much. However, it's feeling
feeling a bit nippy in the cargo hold of Timora's Kiss.
Ooh! Chapel flat pegs.
I hope you've got your long johns on.
Always, always, always.
Raif! Actually, as the barbarian is naked, you should probably take naked. More.
Yeah. He's always naked.
No, I
yeah, but from being always naked, you know, he's built up a strong skin, you see.
Oh, yes, of course.
Natural armor
right now.
So, I'm not even trying to converse with this thing. I'm just walking up and I'm trying to twat it.
You better kill it.
You have twatted it, and you pierce its fine mane, sending blood spurting out all over your face.
Oh.
Can I use my action surge and attack again?
If you have an action surge, you are more than welcome to use it.
A what? Tongue surge! We're not playing that kind of tabletop, alright?
Next time.
Oh, nice!
17 for 8 points of damage.
Oh. So you slam it with your war pick and send blood spurting everywhere, and then follow through with a second. And
you hear
a rib or a bone crack as your pick delves deeper into its body. And Axoneth, you are currently stood on top of a box.
Now here's what you do. You jump on Gwenllian and it fall down on it.
Just jump and bring your axe down.
Do you really want me to do this?
Bring down the axe of wounding.
Alright then, I will
if
jump
misses,
where I am.
If he misses, would he put a hole in the boat?
Right, I will jump from where I am, and as in midair, I will scream, "This is for giving me cold nipples."
So, how are you screaming this? Are you trying to intimidate the beast as your...
Yes, like an imitation war cry kind of thing.
Knock yourself out, make an intimidation check as well as your attack.
So, intimidation first.
Mm-hmm.
If I can find it. Intimidation.
Mm.
You have advantage on your attack roll.
Yes.
So as the semi-naked blue-haired barbarian dives forward with his great axe, he cleaves the wolf's head in two.
Oh.
Nice.
No, not nice.
Nice.
And you hear a yelp and the sound of crushed or sliced and diced cranium.
That's a shame.
And as he lands next to me, I look at him and go, "Be careful with those things, you could cut frickin' diamonds."
Can I sing We Are the Champions after I do that? Just to annoy
you. I'll also give you a fishing truck for it and everything.
I'm a bit upset about this. I'm going to shove the barbarian and say, "Go into your knight."
Oh, I'm
Wolf. Good fight, dude.
Mm.
So, the wolf is dead, and the captain, Heck, has been looking on in just sheer amazement at your prowess. He didn't even bother rousing his crew members, and he sort of resting against the wall goes, "Oh God, I'll never be able to make port in Raven's Landing again!" That was meant to be a gift, you know. I was going to be paid marvellously for that.
Still get a pretty penny for its pelt, I guess.
I apologise, Uncle, but the beast left us no choice.
You, my boy! You said to me that you kicked the bloody box!
I didn't kick the box. The barbarian kicked the box.
I don't know what you're talking about.
If it helps, Uncle, I didn't tell them anything. Kept at my end of the bargain. We came down, it was already attacking the paladin, and we had to do something.
Oh, my boy, I should have to think about this.
Maybe we could get it stuffed.
Throw yourself in it, you foolish boy! I need a drink.
I kind of quickly grab my flask back and go, no.
I get the feeling you've probably had enough already, Uncle.
Don't you tell me what to do!
Oh, well.
Wait until Mother and Father hear about this.
I can't, I just go, yeah, that was fun. I'm just gonna...
And good old Grandpapa.
Old Grandpapa. So, Taron, are you heading up to the main deck?
Yeah, I'm gonna go and see the ocean.
Go and see the ocean.
Can I try to get my dagger back?
You can, yes. Oh, well done. Strength check, please, to yank it out of the crate.
No problem. Oh dear,
yeah.
You go flying backwards and smack your head against the hull. However, if you would like to take a short, long rest, whatever, you can now. The captain is going to sort of mull things over in his cabin. Refuses to speak to any of you during the rest because A, he's slightly hammered on his special reserve, and B, he
did anyone else take any
concerned that he's not going to get paid now.
Yeah, a lot.
Did ya?
Well, here's what you do. You skin the wolf, you tie it round a crazy old man, and you gag the crazy old man.
Are we now blaming this on the crazy old man?
Oh, we're doing.
Okay.
Is there a crow's nest, by any chance?
Yeah, sure.
Anybody up there?
Not at the present moment in time.
I'll go up there and meditate for a bit.
Oh. Alrighty. So, if I just check on my mask. There you go. So, you've hoiked it up to the crow's nest. Would anyone like to go to the upper deck? Because I will do is I'm just going to get rid of the entire dynamic lighting layer in this map.
Hooray!
Cool. So you can move as you wish, where you would like to be, etc, etc. I'm moving.
Ah! Yep, that was fire.
fire bad! There you go. Well, you can roam wherever you like on the ship and place yourselves where you want to be.
Was there anything in the galley?
In the galley, yes, there is, actually. No, now you mention it.
Mm. Can I shout to all the other guys? Can anyone try and get my dagger back for me, please?
As you're taking a rest...
You could probably try it again. You're stronger than I am.
During the resting period, you managed to pull your axe free. Nice. Your axe, your dagger.
Quick question. Could someone remind me how to do the health when you're resting?
If we're taking a long rest, it doesn't matter anyway, it's automatic.
Right. Yeah, you get regain 4 hit points and then you spend hit dice after a long rest. Are you kipping for the night, or are you just sort of milling about, doing stuff, walking around the ship and then having a rest?
Making myself a sandwich.
Having a sandwich. What sort of time frame are we looking at?
I'm going to, like, kip by where I'm sitting, well, there. Because no one's really going to be stupid enough to attack me.
Well, I'm fine, really, so I'm just going to take a nice leisurely rest watching the ocean from the deck.
I want to know this dude's story.
I'm going to sulk in the back of the ship here. Sulk. Cure myself, maybe. Before I have a rest.
Well, as an elf, I can go into a trance. Mm-hmm. So that's what I'm doing.
One!
Ha! If we take a long rest, you don't need to worry about that.
No. Wait a minute, don't you add your thing to it?
Alright.
Are we classing this as a long rest then?
Okay.
Yeah. May as well.
You spend about 8 hours right. Resting up, having a quick kip, or milling about the ship and investigating. Lisummer, the chappy in the galley has just got young seaman.
Favourite.
I am not eating from that galley.
However, he is assisting a portly dwarven woman.
Yeah.
Interesting to find a woman on a ship, even in this day and age.
Excuse me?
Is it a bit fancy?
As a member of the crew, they're generally accepted as guests, but crew-wise, it's generally considered bad luck.
Is what? Yeah. So she's female, yeah.
Correct. She is a female dwarf.
She's hot.
She's got a beard.
She's a dwarf. Of course, she's hot.
I would have made a perception check.
No, I'm totally up for that. I'll roll a perception check.
Ah.
Is that good?
You see a figure.
The dwarven woman you see before you, you believe to be the most beautiful dwarvish woman, the finest specimen of the dwarvish caste.
You're damn right.
However, if someone else were to be sort of stood behind you, they would see a pretty...
Would they be giving you a bit of this?
A pretty, well, they must have met on plenty of fish. she's not the prettiest of the bunch when it comes to dwarves.
Crikey.
But you believe that she's pretty attractive.
I'm going to weave my silver words whilst I ask her to make dinner for the rest of the crew, as instructed by the captain.
Well, aren't you a little cutie? Would you like something special for your tea?
That would be most enjoyable. And you know what they say about small packages?
In your pocket.
And do you have a pocket for me, or a warm pocket?
God.
No, warm, you cheeky wee bugger, you. I've never heard the game before.
I give her a wink and an elbow nudge.
You haven't even asked my name, you cheeky little bugger.
I just assumed your name was Angel.
No!
Yeah!
Make a charisma check.
I think I needed one. Jesus. I should probably have a minus for that as well. No, no, just check, not save. Sorry.
Nice.
No!
There you go.
Nice.
Bam!
And she gives you a big hug and pulls you tight into her large bosom. Gives you a wee peck on the cheek.
Well, I think I'll let her be for now. But I'll give her a wink.
I'll
give her a wink.
Oh, a wink! I was going to make do a performance check then.
Give her a sly wink on the way out. Grab her. I don't know, like some bread and cheese and stroll out.
She gives you, she lets you walk away with the bread and cheese and gives you a little pinch on the bum.
I say, hey, you got to pay for that. Don't come cheap.
If you want anything else, my dear, you just ask old Castrid.
I'll just walk out without saying anything.
You hear dwarven song coming from the galley.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Alrighty, so after your long rest, Taron, what's your meditative? Are you sort of just looking out over the horizon?
Yeah, pretty much.
All right. So, Taron, you are able to see an island that appears to have quite high cliffs and a very, very dense wood on the northern side of the island. You're currently approaching it from the southeast.
All right.
And you're a few miles away, but you can easily reach that with the speed that the ship is currently doing within the next hour or so.
All right, then. So island cliff tree is going to be there soon.
Take it. All right.
Island cliff trees.
Island cliff trees. If you would. I'd like to make a perception check for me, also. Oh! Nice crit.
So my eyes become lasers for a second, like, ah!
Oh, hell yeah! you are able to see, and ascertain, rather, you can see plumes of smoke rising from the blind side of the cliffs, and you are able to discern that it's not your normal sort of smoke. It appears to be all manner of things burning, as if wood and clay and all other things had been
so not like a forest fire, like
not like forest fire, doesn't appear to be chimney fire. You're pretty sure that that smoke is a sign that something's amiss.
Okay, I'm going to kind of like yell down to, like, is there any crew down here?
There's a crew member currently by the captain.
Alright, so I'm going to like kind of yell down. Hey, the smoke! See it?
So he sort of shouts up to you and goes, what? On the island!
Yeah, it is. I think something's on fire. Is there a town up there?
That's Gold Apple Island! I must tell the captain!
I've got an hour to point this out to him. I'm not that.
He doesn't know that. You just shut it down. This smoke!
Yeah, but he's going to come up here, so I've got enough.
Oh, fair enough. So he climbs up and has a look for himself and says,
Dear Lord. Sorry. That doesn't look good to me.
Would it be... It's an island, so would it be pirates then, I guess?
Quite possibly. We've heard tale of the Red Band. I know there were the Red Brands and Sunset, but I'm... Sorry.
Original.
Oh, shut up!
Disadvantage on all the attack rolls.
Thank you. So he says, yes, we've heard tale of the Red. We've not seen them close to the mainland before.
Why? Do you have any weapons on this ship?
As in ship-wise weapons?
Like ship-to-ship combat?
No.
You think you could outrun a pirate ship?
It all depends on the size. If we're running a skiff, then we probably won't be able to.
Can I shout up to them, actually? I somehow heard this, can I shout up to them?
Do me and Gwen have any, like, ship-to-ship combat? No, me and, sorry, Geraldine. Me and Geraldine, because we're both sailors. Mm. Do we have any pirate experience?
I hope not.
Well, you've sailed... And make a history check for me. Come on.
Both of us?
No, not you. Okay. He's about to say the background. Sorry.
That's okay.
History with proficiency or without it? Just straight history?
Oh, with. It's fine as you sailor. Background will give you. I'll give you the bonus.
Well, on yeah, that. I am useless.
Doesn't
matter. Even with the plus two, I'd be even with that bonus, would both be crap.
you've not heard of the Red Band pirates before, and you've not really had any run-ins with pirates on your travels. You may have heard tales, but you've never experienced anything personally.
Do we want to? Is there somewhere else we can dock on the island? Like a beach or something?
I don't know. I'm just a seaman. The captain will probably know.
Yeah, go ask him. Go get him.
So he darts back down. And by this point, about 20 minutes has passed. So you're getting closer. And he goes to the captain. And then they make their way to the chart room. And running out onto the deck is the small figure of Hexshark Spain. Are you still staying up in the crow's nest?
Yeah, well, how long would it take me to stand? Like a couple, like 10, 20 seconds? If I had to get...
You're pretty nippy, so yeah, you could shimmy down quite quickly.
Then I may as well stay up here, then, I guess.
Yep. No. And at this point, all the rest of you are noticing that there's a bit of a hubbub, unless you've also shouted to the other members of your party, Taron.
Yeah, I'm telling, probably yelling, get up here. You probably want to see them. They've probably heard about it by now.
Mm-hmm.
Just to chat on the ship.
What's happening?
You can probably only fit two people at a time up in the crow's nest. But if you want, if someone wants to be totally filled in and see for yourself, Taron can fill you in. And
you not see the smoke from the front of the ship?
From where you are, you've got the sort of advantage of being able to see
the smoke coming out from the blind of the island. By this point, as you're getting closer, it's getting harder and harder to see the smoke coming out. The wind direction is heading northeast, so you're able to see it from the blind.
Here's what I'll do. I'll shimmy down the scaffolding and help anyone up if you want to get up there and see it.
Mm-hmm. So you're all pretty...
I'm cool as long as you tell me what's going on and point me in the right direction to stab things.
I'm the same. Just tell me where to stab and just tell me why we're doing it, generally.
Just a quick question. None of you are going to be the tactical leader for this, Dan.
Nope.
I am really tactical. I always make sure that my war pick is in my right hand because that's my strong hand.
Right. Alright. Okay. Yeah.
So you've fully appraised the rest of the party as to what you've seen and what's going on. A couple of you have gone up and had a look. And Heck says, "This simply can't be. That's Gold Apple Island. They make the best bloody cider in the whole world.
They appear to have been raided. Or can we tell from here?"
From where you are, you're unable to see in the port because the island sort of curves in on itself. And it's on the southwestern side is the way you'd be able to see into the small town. The small house on the island. And
pirates. Sorry, go on.
Go on.
Pirates would be the more mundane thing to jump to.
Mm-hmm. Heck is more informed than the crew member of the band. He knows and says to you that the Red Band are goblin-like pirates that normally cause trouble on the eastern coast, and it's very strange for them to be on the south coast, especially this close to the mainland. So it may not be the Red Bands, and the crew member will probably be flogged for saying such things. And, you know, making people scared for no reason. But he asks you, after seeing your ability to destroy a beautiful winter wolf, he asks that you investigate the island for him, because he needs to make a pickup of cider to take to the mainland.
Alright, here's what we do. We'll pull up beside the cliff, we'll get in a wee long boat, and the party will get to the island, because that seems the safest option.
Sounds good to me.
Anyone else got an idea?
No, I think that sounds like a very good idea. I would not want to put my legacy into any danger.
You just don't want to lose your shirt.
Thing. I can't stand it. It's pirates.
So, well, you two being sailors, I would assume you have a dislike for pirates anyway, so...
Well, yeah, but it's the more they're under looting.
Unless they were piratical themselves.
Not at all.
No.
No.
So that's what the paladins hide in.
I'm not hiding, well, no, anything.
Honest, Gov, it wasn't me. So, what I'm going to just do now is chuck you all in on that map, and then we'll cover what's going on.
Oh my god.
If we're going in a little rowboat, can we have the board sing row-row-rowy-boat?
Oh dear.
Totally can. I'll do it.
If you sing it quietly, yeah.
We'll do it around.
Three-part harmonies, yes. Just like in Star Trek.
Yep.
Roll, you pulled.
Roll.
I suddenly feel seasick.
Oh, pretty. Wow, our boat shrunk a bit.
So you're currently in the rowboat.
Rowboat.
The Timora's kiss has moored up on this side of the island, and there is smoke emitting from the little hamlet where the dock is. If you can see my pins, I don't know whether you can.
Yeah,
cool. As the second screen is just not playing nicely. the cliff faces are about 100 feet tall.
That's cliff face.
So everything essentially is high cliff, and it descends down to the port, which is obviously at sea level. This here and the one on the opposite side, obviously you can't quite see all of the map. All you can see is the cliffs. This is like a giant stone spire that raises up yet another 100 feet above the cliff.
Right, well, if all we can see is cliff, the only way we've got of going in is via the port.
Yeah. Do we see any ships in the port?
Mm-hmm. You currently don't see anything in the port whatsoever. All you get is burning buildings.
Well, that's a good sign. Nobody's here. Well, I don't mean the fire and the death and the destruction. I just mean the fact that the pirates aren't here right now.
Right, well, I still think it's probably a wise idea if we swiftly make our way to the port.
Yeah.
Can
Alright, well, here's the thing. I'm going to be looking.
Building.
You tell me at what point can I make a check to see what caused the destruction of these buildings? Like, does it look like cannon fire, or does it look like something stranger?
You probably wouldn't be able to discern that from within the boat. More than likely need closer inspection.
Right. Fair enough. Can we move the boat?
Yes, you can. Right. Well, you should be able to. Yes. Yeah, there you go.
Right. Ah, there we go. Whee!
We'll pull in here.
Eeny, meeny.
I can say, always go in the left dock.
Well, we'll go actually peer closer to this middle bit, you think. Can you... Wait a minute. Let's just... Give me a minute. Let's just... We force back in.
Are you reversing the boat in?
Morning, Theodore McQuarty.
Sorry, go on.
No, I'm done.
Carry on.
I was just going to say, does it all look safe and stable, or is it rotting or anything?
The port itself looks in good order. Obviously, the island of Gold Apple was set to be delivering cider to Tamara's Kiss, and is generally well regarded on the mainland. You've also heard of it in Newstone, as the Gold Apple Press is served there in the taverns.
Okay, without hesitation, I jump off the boat and run towards the scene.
Right, you are. Just point out that the map scale is 1 square equals 10 feet, so you're large. You are not giants, I'm afraid.
Damn it!
How did you do that, guys?
Again?
How did you jump out of the ship?
I'm doing it.
Ah.
Yeah.
Right. I calmly watch to see if he gets eaten.
Yeah, so you said this one's on fire, this one.
Very
on...
often?
It's the entire place on fire.
The houses in the sort of the landing area appear to have been put to the torch. However, there is a large building on the southern cliff that is not burning.
Right, well, I'm going to run to the building that's not burning and find out where everybody is.
I knew you'd say that.
So as you get to there, Ray...
Okay, I'll stop moving now.
You see a stone sort of exit. There's a metal banded and studded wooden door surrounded by a stone tunnel.
Okay. Is the door closed, I assume?
The door is closed.
Can I open the door? Is it barred or...?
You can give it a shake if you like. You give it a rattle. No sort of give whatsoever. So you can sort of guess that it's been barred on the inside.
Can I give it a knock and shout out, we're here to help, we're friendly?
Like a style, you can do. Would you like to do that?
I would like to do that, please.
And how long would you like to wait for a response?
I'll give it a couple of minutes.
You hear nothing but the sound of the breeze and the trees and the crackling of fire.
I'm going to attempt to force the door.
Okie dokie, make a strength check.
If you crit this...
Before I make the strength check, is there anywhere I can wedge my crowbar in? Can I use the crowbar for leverage, or is it too... There's not
it
really
appears
any...
to be quite flush. You can try and wedge it in if you like. I may add a bonus to your roll after the fact. We'll see what you get.
Okay, well, I would like to try and wedge the crowbar in first. Mm-hmm. So what would you like me to roll?
Strength, please.
Check. Okay, not save.
Is there a difference now?
Yeah, there is. Different roles.
Oh, yeah. Alright, check. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because the saving throw is for when you're being attacked.
Oh, you are a sod.
Oh, dear.
Oh, God. You don't appear to move the door whatsoever.
Damn it!
Can I go and try?
I was going to say... I think
would
athletics
be the check here?
Can athletics and I
be the check for what exactly?
Would athletics be? Could they be using athletics instead of strength?
To barge the door down.
Yeah.
No.
What if Axe and I both attempted to assist one another barging the door down?
I give you advantage.
Hello.
Shall we go, old boy?
Let's have a good old crack. Which one?
Strength, please.
Check.
Bollocks.
Advantage.
I got a 21.
Which direction? Are you trying to knock it open, or are you trying to lever it open? So as in, knock it forward, or lever it out?
I've got a feeling it will probably be better to lever it out, then knock it backwards.
Yeah.
Very good, very good, very good. You hear a loud crunch as the bar is broken.
I was going to say, please tell me that's not my back.
No, that would have been one.
Can we see anything down the hall?
Yes, you can. As the light sort of pulls in down the tunnel, and you've also got dark vision, I now remember.
It's you, weird.
I know. You and dark vision. You see the tunnel goes down about 30 feet. What's the extent of your dark vision?
60 feet.
60 feet. Okie dokie. You can see that it opens out into a larger room. And there's also the room, what appears to be a room or another corridor, to the west and 5 foot in the corridor.
Right, well, I'm going down the hall. And
have
I'm
you
gonna yell
the red pill or the blue pill?
And I'm gonna shout to everybody else to follow.
What? Everybody in the hall.
Everybody in the hall.
And wow. As down there?
As we come running down the hall, everybody shout Leroy Jenkins.
Why are we going down?
Can anyone bring chicken?
Because we're going down the hall.
That's a good answer.
If there are people, this is where they will be.
Why would they be down a hole?
Hiding.
It's either that or we try and put the fire out, and I'm not being funny, I'm not trained as a fireman.
There's a forest. Why would you hide in a hole when there's a forest?
Yeah, but I'm sure that the bard doesn't have a song for putting out fires.
Fucking demoralize the fire.
The fire feels very depressed.
Yeah, it's kind of gets put down.
Starts to reassess its situation in the world.
Well, you could do a rain dance, assumedly.
Yeah.
Anyway, down the hall.
So yeah, I'm going down the hall. If anybody doesn't want to come down the hall, that's fine. I just want to go down the hall.
You need light. We need some of us need torches or something.
I'll go down the hall.
You're going down the hall?
I'm going down the hall.
You're going down the hall.
Have you not got dark vision as a...
I do, but I'm thinking about the humans. I'm not a dick.
I've got torches anyway. We're good, shut up. Down the hall.
We'll light the torch then.
Right, light a torch. There you go. Then we're in the hall.
Yeah, go down the hall.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Yeah.
Please don't put the torch near my face, because I've got dark vision and it will blind me.
I say right in the fight back, thanks, okay?
That's fine, I'll lead the charge.
Let
the second shortest to the group lead the way, don't worry.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Oh, come on, you bastard. Wood open, there we go, that's better. Bloody stupid tokens.
I have a feeling he didn't want us to go this way.
Well, no, I'm open to any sort of direction you go. So
level 20 boss fight ahead.
Yeah.
I can't help it. I'm sorry. I see a hole. I want to get in the hole.
You find in the pit the Tarask.
You find Tiamat.
Yeah.
I fancy me odds.
Fall in a pit of acid.
Bastard!
Boing.
You're eaten by a crew.
There we go, you are now in the hole.
How am I gonna... Ooh.
Do I have a torch that's working right now? I don't know.
Sorry, did you light a torch?
Yes, I did.
You did.
Yes, it did.
Okay, bear with me a second then, please. and it would help if the torch API was working, which it bloody isn't.
Look on the bright side, if I lead the charge down here, if anybody's behind me and they have ranged weapons, they can just shoot over my head.
Hi, Axe. Do you want me to hold George? Because you need both your hands for your greatsword.
Good point, actually. I will give him the torch.
Ah!
No. Sorry. Just realised.
I'll hold you.
Just tuck it in your loincloth.
Shove it up your ass.
Oh, hold it in your teeth.
Singe me wooden cloth. Just what I need right now.
Right. I'm actually I'm gonna keep it on Axe Hunath because Taron, you've got dark vision, and because we're all 20 only allows you to put one light source and whether I place it or not, it's a pain in the ass.
Okay.
So you'll lose your dark vision if I give you a torch on the thing.
That's fine. That's like same thing applies really.
Yeah. So you see it's about 5 foot across and approximately 10 foot high.
It's very fucking roomy down here.
It's roomy for a gnome. Yeah. And the bard.
Mm. The bard and I are perfectly comfortable.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy this is in the stinking hobbit hole.
This is a tight hole.
I think to myself.
In the room to the west, you see there's a sconce on the wall with an unlit torch and a large collection of firkins.
So I shouldn't have.
Well, seems as the bard's already in that room. Does he want to go and light the torch for us?
Yeah, I'll go and light the torch. In the sconce. Have I got tinder? Have I got that?
You got a tinder box? You have an adventure sketch?
No, not
going to
stop. Okay. I'll pull out a tinder box and throw it to him.
Yeah. Cheers. I'll catch it. Bard style. And light it.
You light up the torch.
Yeah.
And what you see in the
tiny room.
You get the faint vinegary smell of fermented apples. That have stained the floor, and obviously there's still the large collection of barrels.
Okie dokie. I'm gonna.
Are any of the barrels full?
You can make an investigation check if you like.
Okie dokie.
Any of the
on the barrels?
Yep. Investigation.
Call
it. I find sweet FA.
Wait a second, these are barrels of ale, aren't they?
They don't do ale, it's cider. It's cider.
Yeah. I kind of lean out and I kind of back an axe in. Hey, just, you've got that stuff here. It's cider.
But can I at least tell they're cider?
You think they're apple juice.
Can I do apple a perception juice. Check?
Yeah, you can do a perception check if you like. Ooh, that's good. So, you can see that these are all stamped with Gold Apple Cider Company. And while you're sort of checking out the barrels, you see a note laid on top of one of the barrels. And that was, I almost said Catherine.
Oops.
I've been waiting for that all night.
Oh, I didn't give the character names, it just gives the player names on the list. There we go. And so you pick up the slip of paper. And you should now see it on your screen.
Should I read it to everybody else?
You can do. You can say, "Oh, I've just found this." You can pass it around, or you can say what it is.
Just found a note, guys. So if I pass it around, you can all read it.
Cool.
Okay. Yep. So I'm just checking everyone else's box. There we go. And blink. So, yeah, what you pick up is a slip of paper that's dated the fourth day of New Flower, 440 SC, which was yesterday now.
Oh, yes.
As you took a long rest, and you're on the second day of your adventuring. A shipping list. The port of Raven's Landing, collection ship Timora's Kiss, captained by Heck. The Rusty Halberd, 3 firkins, 1 kilderkin. The Trading Post, 3 firkins. And the Salty Sea Dog, 2 kilderkins and 2 firkins.
This is what we were supposed to pick up.
Indeed. You ascertain that this is the shipment that was due to be loaded onto Timora's Kiss.
What's a kilderkin?
Kilderkin is an 18-gallon barrel.
Ah, it's not some kind of...
No, just a small drink, then.
A firkin is 9 gallons, a pin is 3 gallons, a kilderkin is 18, and a hogshead is 36.
Yes.
Not that I used to work with beer at all.
No, I know. What a ton is. I know what a ton is. I don't know anything about anything else.
Yeah, we'll grab them when we come back, because my uncle will probably want those, seems as we killed his prize wolf.
If they're still found, yes.
None's got to get themselves paid.
Well, I think this is a thing, like, if pirates, assumedly this is what they'd be robbing, really, if it was pirates.
Yeah, but obviously they didn't pass the strength check to open the door.
Like, there's a crew of pirates, assumedly you could break down the door eventually.
Pirates like gold. Gold.
I'm going to come down here and light these sconces, please, with my tinderbox.
Yeah, sure.
Just so the humans can see.
Do you want me to just use a torch?
Yeah, you have a lit torch. You don't need to use up your tinderbox.
Well, yeah, either or.
Alrighty, so the lighting up that one. And that one.
Is that it?
Yeah, is there anything in this room?
It's a rather confined room.
There's
a door on the northwest side of it, and there are three large barrels, hogsheads, just FYI, in the room, stood upright, and two large bags of yeast on the eastern side. The strong sort of vinegary, cidery smell is even more prominent in this room.
Ah, we're getting to the good stuff, guys. Does anybody want to do anything in this room before I check the door?
Is there anything else in the room?
What's this in the corner?
Yeah.
What's what? The bags of yeast.
Oh,
okay.
Give the barrels a quick tap, like, see if there's drinking there.
Yeah, you give them a quick ding ding, and you can tell that they're quite full. If anyone who is a frequenter of taverns and cellars, etc., knows a little bit out of the process, would like to make any sort of check to discern what this room might be, you're welcome to.
I've been with my fair few share of taverns in my time.
I haven't been in this area, really, so I can't.
I'm propping up the bar. Can I do a performance check?
A performance check?
That's my question.
What would we be trying to be for?
To perform a perception on these barrels.
Wait, you could do a performance check to say with any sort of authority to the rest of the group, if you like.
Yeah. Maybe I'll just do a perception.
Doing the guided tour.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Here we go.
Oh, no.
No.
You know that there are barrels and yeast in this room.
But I will tell the rest of the party that I know exactly what it is. This is the room where they actually roll out all of the apples by foot. Like, they roll them on the hard concrete, and that's how they make the really good stuff. This is what this is. It's called the apple rolling room.
And Rafe's just stood there holding his chin and nodding. And, very interesting. Thank you very much for sharing that information.
What? And it's usually the apple rolling is done by the third sister of every family. So if you have three girls, it's always the eldest. So the younger sister will do it.
This dude's fishing for extra XP here.
And apple bobbing for extra XP.
Oh!
Oh!
Good show, sir.
That's minus an extra couple of rooms for XP.
Can I... Is the door locked? Do I know? Does it look like it can be locked? Does it have a keyhole?
The doors in this sort of section don't appear to have any locks.
I'm going to swing the door open, please.
I think they were depending entirely on the big barred door at the front.
Oh, so whenever I'm playing a rogue, I have to open every door, but whenever someone else says, you just open the door yourself. That's how it is then.
Yeah.
Hey, we work so well as a team when we're a rogue, right? Think about all those times you made me move into position so you could get your little sneak attack bonus.
Yeah. That was nice.
Yes.
So you fling the door open.
Fling!
Snooze.
Yeah, I'll go with fling.
And as you do so, did you step through?
I flung and stepped through to here. Right. Well, I would imagine so. That's stepping through the door, isn't
it? Yep, you flung it and stepped through. So, I would like you, Squire, to make a dexterity check.
God damn.
Whoops.
Saving throw, dear.
Oh no, I'm sorry. Hang on a second. I wrote that down wrong.
My apologies.
I would like you to make
saving throw, please.
That's good.
I have a feeling I'm about to get hurt.
You're gonna get murdered by a door.
Yeah, I'm gonna get hurt.
No!
How?
So,
that's one of your good things.
As you step through the door, after slinging it open, you hear a click from above.
Oh no!
What did
grenade!
What did I say?
Down drops a crudely made net on top of you, and you are taken to the floor under the weight of the net.
Gonna be honest, guys, not the first time I've ever been under a net.
I used to know a net.
And you are currently restrained. I forgot that part.
It's usually me doing the restraining, but I'll go with it.
Guys, little decorum.
He's fine.
That made me shake the pot.
And so, I yell out to the rest of the group, a little help here, please.
So, as you're in quite a confined area, and your current order of march is Gwenllian behind Gwenllian, what would you like to do?
Set the net on fire.
Is it just a net?
it's a crudely made net of rope, and there's some weights on it for when it dropped down. And Raif is entangled in it.
Hmm. Can I try cutting it off with one of the daggers?
You can.
Or would it be better? Would it be better to just try and pull it off?
Either or, dear. It's fine.
I'll try it with the dagger, try cutting it off. Is that,
Just make a standard attack for me with the dagger.
Please
speak up.
Oh, nice.
Oh,
nice.
In a mighty flurry of daggerness, you slice almost immaculately, around Raif and sort of fling the remaining piece of net up in the air, and then you do it.
and you get a little string of men.
Nice. And I just turn and say to everyone, I told you I wasn't all that bad.
So I'm going to get up now.
Wait a second. I think you're using strength for your attacks instead of dexterity.
Really?
Like, I'm assuming you're dexterity based instead of a really buff kind of rogue. I might be wrong. But
the attacks are no bonus on the attacks.
No, I mean, like, normally as a rogue, this is a finesse weapon, you can use your dexterity, but is she using her dexterity?
Oh, no.
What?
Yeah, you might want to do that because you get extra damage.
Yeah, dex is even better.
You're better with dex.
Yeah. Well spotted, man. Right.
Like, I just didn't notice because you're actually surprisingly strong for a rogue.
So, yeah,
She rolled well for her character creation.
Oh, no. I decided to stick with my first and then I rolled second to see how it would go, and I rolled so much better on the second. I was really pissed off. I did. I was quite upset I didn't do the second one then.
So, in this corridor, there is another sconce wall with an unlit torch, a door, and a set of steps that begin in the corridor and then spiral up and around.
Well, I'm going to move forward gingerly whilst looking around. Mainly looking up. And going to make my way to the door.
Yeah.
And I would like to... Well, firstly, call for the rest of the group to follow me. In hopes that once he passes the sconce, the monk would light it with the torch that he's holding.
Mm-hmm. Consider it done.
And then I'm going to check out this door. Now, learning from my past mistake, can I do a check to see if there's anything odd about the door?
You can make an investigation check.
Be able to
say again
what direction these stairs are going, that they might lead back up to that building that was on the top of the cliff to our west.
16
will do it. You don't appear to notice any sort of booby trap.
Okay, I'm going to look to the rest of the group and then open the door.
Do you think those stairs go up to the building? The other building? The one that was on the cliff?
Possibly, but it's probably best to check out this floor then first.
Yeah, finish doing this floor and then check them.
And I step into the room gingerly.
So as you step gingerly into the room, you see a large workbench and a stool. There's a sconce on the wall above the bench, and this room is only 15 foot at its longest by 20 foot. There is a sort of alcove. Inverted alcove? I'm lost for words. in the northwestern side, so it narrows quite sharply. There's an assortment of strips of wood, and you can sort of ascertain that this is where they make up fresh barrels.
Is there anything else of interest in the room?
There doesn't appear to be. However, there is a half full mug of cider
on the workbench.
There's an empty mug of cider on the bench.
As well as smoking.
Is the smoking pipe still warm?
It certainly is.
Mm.
Right.
Alright. They know we're coming. Whoever they are.
Right. Okay, time to investigate the stairs then, I think, people.
To the stairs! Play with some music then, Bard, on the way up.
I'm going to stand at the bottom of the stairs and have a look. You said they go up?
Or yes, they do. They go up.
Right. Can I see anything from where I am? Or?
It appears to be in darkness. From where you are, the light coming from the sconce sort of just licks the top of the stairs. And you can see it curves round. But that's about all you can ascertain.
Okay, well,
I'm running away again.
I'm gonna walk up the stairs.
Yep.
Seems as everybody else is chicken.
Who's chicken? Who are you calling chicken?
You're now in a separate part of this map. You're on the upper level.
I'm going upstairs.
Everybody upstairs.
Everyone's going upstairs. Whoop,
whoop, whoop, whoop. Gangnam style. I kind of quickly look under the desk.
Do you want to make an investigation check for me?
Yeah, why not? Nah, I don't see fan shit.
You see nothing.
I'm assuming at this point our kleptomaniac paladin has picked up the smoking pipe.
I couldn't help it.
Is this another door by where I am now?
Yep, that is another door there. And let me just move Taron up as well. Whoops, there's it.
Oh, wow. Hello.
Stop it!
Again, now it's on.
There's another door there and another set of steps leading up.
Guys, I don't know where I was in some weird place. Then I was here on the stairs again.
Okay, can I check this door?
You can. Make us another investigation.
I'm just a little bit wary now.
Well, yeah, you got trapped.
I don't see anything wrong with this door whatsoever.
You do not.
In fact, I'm not even quite sure it's even a door.
Maybe you should be letting a professional do this. I mean.
Oh, whoops!
I think you're all better than not.
Or I can just follow my character bio and just push the door open.
Yeah, well, you're Lorne eventually.
Oh, it's your character bio. I like it, you're playing to your character.
I'm not actually this stupid.
You push open the door and make a dexterity check, please.
Oh, good God, man.
I told you you'd Lorne.
That's gonna be.
That's good.
Close up. A 20.
So, as you push open the door, three bolts fly over your head and cling into the stone behind you.
Oh, shit. Oh, it's alright.
Okay. I'm just gonna shrug my shoulders and walk into the room.
Well,
very well.
I'm telling you, you just gotta play to the character. I can't do anything about it.
All right.
See, I would run in that room, jazz handing.
Damn it!
That's just my character.
So, I want a jazz hand.
As you step into the room, you see what appears to be a hastily rigged sort of crossbow contraption. Right in front of you there, which isn't placed on the map, I apologise. I thought I'd put it on there.
And that's what shot the bolts at me.
That, you can pretty much ascertain that's what fired the bolts as you open the door. There is a small piece of string now.
Would you mind awfully making sure that that's safe? Before we go any further?
Can I please twat it?
Good Lord.
I was going to steal that. I bought her.
I want to twat the crossbow. I don't like being shot at.
You know what? Dibs on next door.
Who's that?
I want to do the next door, that's all I'm saying.
Oh, you, okay, it's a
you
hack.
You smack it and the mechanism lets out a twang.
Oh dear.
That's enough for me. Is well, I can see in this room, but the humans won't be able to. So, is the elf anywhere around with the?
Sorry, I wasn't. I didn't want to kind of. I'm gonna slide past people in a second. So, excuse me.
Sorry.
Don't mind me.
I like the torches.
Ah.
So you illuminate the room.
And there was light. Good.
There is also a very small amount of light coming down a shaft, as you can see on the map there. That sort of lands in a giant wooden leather contraption with two giant screw handles at either end and a large plank of wood.
Does it smell like apples?
It smells distinctly of apples in this room.
There we are.
And there's also a chute.
You know what this is? This is the Golden Island Press.
Indeed.
I didn't know they had a newspaper.
Wow. Presses.
So there's a half barrel. Used to collect the pressed apples that has been knocked over. Again, it appears to be in some haste. And there's a trickle of cider heading down towards this end of the room, where it appears to disappear under the wall.
Oh, hello.
Oh, that isn't dodgy at all.
You've got high passive perception, all right?
I want to investigate that corner of the room, if I may.
Knock yourself out. What's your passive perception?
I've been trying 14. To do that with the doors, but it ain't working.
You got 14. Make an investigation. Go on. Do it again. You love investigation.
I am so good at investigation.
May call you Sherlock.
You'll need the pipe you got.
What pipe?
I have no idea about a pipe.
Maybe you could investigate what he means.
No, I'm not going to find anything whatsoever.
Wow, you're pretty smart. Actually, you are pretty smart.
Can I do a perception check?
Yeah, go on.
Could I just hit the wall?
Oh. You can do if you want. You're
why? Allow the rogue to do her investigation or perception first.
Oh, right. Gwenllian. You notice that the wall, that sort of segment of wall there, that 5 foot piece, appears to be slightly high. It doesn't seem to be actually any sort of supporting wall whatsoever. And the spilled apple juice is actually going right underneath that bit of wall.
Relay that information to the rest.
And then, when you're looking at it, an axe suddenly slams into it.
Blade of glory!
Are you allowed me to do this?
Yeah, of course you
can.
Shit!
Yes!
Yes! So, just as you step away and you're about to say, I think this might be a secret.
You think?
This giant great axe sort of swings into it, and the stone just sort of flies open with a loud clang. And Raif, Gwenllian, Gwenllian and anyone with a sort of high sense of smell, you get struck with a warm, dank sort of salty water, as well as dampness, you know, black rot sort of smell suddenly bursts out from the now open passageway.
I would like to enter the passageway.
Oh, Christ. What's this thing again, by the way?
That's an apple press.
Oh.
I am...
Let me just look behind it for a second.
Yeah, sure. Quick question. Knock out an investigation.
Did anybody lick the press?
Damn it!
Just to check it was an apple press.
Oh god, you're really sucking at these investigation checks, Taron.
I actually have a plus one, but yeah.
God damn!
Well, I've been having good attack roll, so it balances out.
Dude, tell me about it. Right? I got a plus two on investigation. I can't do jack.
It works right. Once I get the absorbent feat, it's going to make things a lot easier.
Yep, you are going to be an investigating fiend.
No, actually, I'm not. I'm just going to be really... If I actually try, I won't find anything. It's really stupid.
Yeah, but you'll know it's there anyway, just by glancing.
Alright, so we're going to check this secret room before, so go ahead.
I'm already, like, checking.
The secret room is actually a sort of a concealed stairway that turns down and heads quite far down.
Everybody down the stairs.
Say again?
Everybody down the stairs.
Everyone down the stairs. So, you descend quite far down. Gradually the walls change from carved stone to natural, very moist, natural rock. Has anyone got stone cutting or anything like that?
Let me see what I can bullshit.
I'm going to go with a no, considering I'm a forest gnome.
Yeah, I'm a fucking wood elf. I've got nothing. Is stone a type of wood?
Yeah, so at this point, the wood elf and the gnome are just looking at each other going, I've never seen this type of tree before.
This is a strange type of tree.
Can I bluff the fact that I know what it is?
Oh dear.
Good ending.
If no one else is going to do it.
You can try. What
would that be? Well, I've got perception.
Yeah.
I don't suppose that will work.
Deception.
Perception could work.
Deception check. No, not really. I spiel some obviously fake bullshit about the stone.
I'll shake the little jar.
So after about 5 minutes of steady pace descent, the steps sort of completely disappear, and it's just natural rock that you're now steady on. Again, there doesn't appear to be any sort of light.
Oh, funny shape.
Dark. Raif, you can probably see. What is the order of march?
I was in front, I know that much.
Hold where you are, Raif. Hold where you are.
I was trying to make room for everybody else.
Good man. It is a very confined area. So, as you head descend deeper and deeper, you gradually hear the sound of crashing waves above your head. And that sort of salty, damp smell is it increased. Am I missing someone? Yes, I am missing someone. Taron. Yeah.
Yay.
I can't remember how to turn on my dark vision.
Am I still missing someone?
You know that green button on the side of your head? That's the dark vision button. You've got to press that and then woof.
Ah, the bard. There we go.
There I am.
There he is.
Oh, that's still quite a damn thing. Oh, wait, there I am.
There we go. So, the ceiling sort of gets even higher now. It's about 40 foot high, and there's
anything.
The echoey sort of sound.
Oh, wait. Oh, there we are.
Yeah, there it's the clipping, because it is very, very tight and moist passage. What?
I'm just going to turn around to the entire group and go, ground floor, kitchenware and homeware.
Oh, really?
What the hell is going on with this edit token? For fuck's sake.
It's all come to a grindy halt, really.
I can't put a light on anyone because they've... What the hell?
I have light.
Yeah, my edit token bar has turned into some... Oh, I know why. Because I'm doing it from the player one.
I'm good, I can see.
I can't see.
Hang on.
Where is everyone?
What's going on?
Hello, you're in a room.
Stop swinging my axe willy-nilly.
There we go.
Ah.
Cool.
So this sort of descends further down, and as you go further down into the tunnel, the sound of crashing waves intensifies above your head.
Do you guys want me to lead again, since I'm the stupid one that got
you? No, I'll go first, because I did say I'll go through the next door.
But... You did say that.
And I'm somehow on light source, but not understand where the torch is.
Yeah, arrows follow behind you. At a nice safe distance.
I need to be near the torch, I can't see anything. I'm dark.
Shall I just keep going until I find something, or...?
Yeah, just...
Well, so you keep going, and when you fall in the hole, we'll stop.
Good plan.
I like you.
Works for me. If the paladin wants to follow those too closely, you'll be able to see what's going on.
I understand. Yeah.
Shall I go around the corner, maybe?
Yes. No, I don't walk this one, I guess.
So as you get to there, you see that the cavern sort of really stretches out, and it's about 60 foot high at this point, and there's a drop in the ceiling in the centre of the cavern that just touches the tip of the water that goes further down.
Interesting. We'll walk to the edge and... Well, it looks like we're going for a swim then.
Oh no.
Good
job, I'm already hot naked.
Hey man, you're already wearing your swimming trunks, it's fine.
Is it? So, wait a minute. Does the pool go, like, is this just walk face, or it's...
There's about 10 foot of water in front of you. That's then met by the cavern ceiling dropping down.
How deep is the water?
It's quite murky. Looks like it. There's particles of mud floating about in it.
Here's the problem. Normally, I would suggest the barbarian does this because he's the strongest and probably holds his breath, but he can't see down there.
I have an idea. I chuck Raif in, just us, and we'll find out how deep he is.
What's Raif wearing?
None of your business what Raif's wearing.
Heavy armor or something?
I have armor on, yeah.
That, no, I didn't. Well, that's going to be interesting.
Has anybody got any inflatable arm bandages?
So, how long do we wait after the bubbles have stopped together? Do we assume he found a hole, or do we assume he's dead?
Well, I'm going to go like this, guys. I think it's probably a good idea I take my chainmail off.
Yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
I've got an explorer's pack.
Yes.
What is in that exactly?
10-foot pole.
No, wait a minute. Maybe any equipment. Yeah.
There's a 10-foot pole in the explorer's pack. There's always a 10-foot pole.
How big is the pack?
Has a backpack, a bed roll, a mess kit, a tinderbox, 10 torches, 10 days of rations, and a water skin, and also has 50 feet of rope.
So I also have 50 feet of rope.
Yes. I also have 50 feet of rope.
And so do I.
Wow!
So let's tie some rope to him before he goes down there.
Right. One pull means I've encountered a mermaid.
two pulls is leave me alone, I'm good.
And three pulls is get me out of here quick.
Wrong type of mermaid.
Or three mermaids.
Now that'd be more than three tugs, it's playing with himself.
Okay, so I'm going to remove my armor, which you guys are going to need to hold for me and remind me to put back on at some point.
While you're removing your armor, could the bard play some kind of sexy music?
Yes, yes it can. I'll tune my lute into drop D and play some
saddest of all
funky, the funky jazz.
Okay, so I'm going to tie rope around my waist.
Yep.
I'm going to hand the other end of the rope to Axe because he's probably the biggest and strongest and could probably pull me out the quickest.
It's a yeah. Girl. Doesn't mean I'm not strong. But you're probably right.
Well, he's also right next to me. And, you know, he needs something to do, otherwise he'll get distracted.
This is very true. I'll somehow make a fishing pole.
Wait, I'm the bait.
Yeah, you're literally my fishing pole. Sorry, you went.
You know,
I'm not taking my shield with me, but I am taking my pick with me.
If you want me to give you a help, I can give you a wee speed boost.
Can you?
Yeah.
You're going to kick me in, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm going to knock you 15 feet right down.
I'd rather not take the damage. I'm just going to jump in the water and go.
It'd be fine. Like, your head has a skull. You know,
that's what it goes for.
I'm just going to go into the water and see how far it goes.
All right, you know. All right. But
so
if you drown by 15 feet, then you know who to. It was your fault.
How deep is this?
You
don't. Bearing
in
mind, I'm 3 foot tall.
You are 3 foot tall. So it doesn't really get gradual because it's already on a slope. It just sort of goes down and down and down. Are you swimming about? Are you literally just trying to get to the bottom to see how far it goes?
No, I'm trying to go forward.
Righty ho, so you're going forwards.
And
can you see at the moment? I'm just trying
I
to figure
can.
Out.
I can.
But it's slightly obscured, correct?
Yeah, I've got what looks like rock face either side of me.
Yeah, cool, that's fine. So while you're descending, it's very murky, so even with dark vision, it's not doing you much good. You can see it's the rock coming down.
Okay, well, I'm trying to stay as close to the top as possible to make
sure. So you're sort of shimmying underneath.
Yeah, trying, trying to make sure that I don't run out of oxygen.
Because that would be bad.
Yes.
I've seen this movie. And the midget dies first.
Right. Well, actually, the black guy dies first.
Oh!
Oh, right.
That was an observation of cinema. That's fine.
I'm sorry.
Make a perception check for me.
A perception check, yeah?
Yes.
God damn it.
And everyone that's currently in the cave on dry land, I would like you to roll initiative, please.
Oh,
come on.
Like a what?
Hang on, you say you're a hacky slashy, and when I ask you to roll initiative, you say, oh, come on.
Yeah, I didn't do so great with my perception, I only got a 12.
You did all right. I would also like you to roll initiative as well, please.
I just want to say, as adventurers, we reserve the right to complain about everything before that, even if it's completely our fault.
Exactly.
Oh, and why have you not been added to the turn order? Come on, roll 20. So, first of all, as you hear the of Raif going further under the water investigating, you also hear behind you the echoes of a rather rough dialect saying, ah, what was that? You found a door!
Uh-oh.
Hmm.
Oh, Raif. Oh, dear.
Oh, come on.
Oh, dear.
Natural one, baby. Natural one.
Oh, dear.
Well, at least it was only initiative.
Oh, yeah, only initiative while I'm not wearing armor.
Well, you're just safe underwater. Unless a shark attacks you.
Can you ever be safe underwater?
It's calamari time.
If you're a fish.
You're going to do well. You're there.
Is now a good time to mention that I took the water breathing trait even though it doesn't exist?
I've scuba gear.
So, Raif, we'll deal with you first, if I may.
Damn it.
So, thanks to your awesome perception check, you noticed a sort of swarm of piranha-like fish scurry about you, and they come at you from all sides, and they're swarming around your body. Shit.
No, it's fine. It's a swarm. It's like a swarm of rats. Please tell me it's like a swarm of rats.
It's like a swarm of rats.
Oh, God.
You've taken your armour off, correct, to go diving?
Well, I had no choice. If I didn't, I would have probably sunk to the bottom.
So, let me just quickly edit you and take your armour off.
I've already taken my armour off.
Oh, you've already taken your armour off?
And my shield, because I'm not taking my shield either. I have an AC.
Oh,
have
AC,
an AC.
Of, AC of 11. That's fine.
I don't think it's too bad, considering I'm not wearing any armour.
Yeah.
that was an indicative death knell. So these this swarm of angry-looking tiny fish start pinching and gnashing at you, and... when did it say the damage?
1d3.
Shut up.
Damn it.
Yeah, roll 1d3 20 times.
Yeah. Oi. Quiet, you.
Sorry, wrong.
They rolled 20 criticals.
God.
Oh, no, that's not going to work, is it? Because it's being an ass.
Oh, God. Shit.
How dead am I?
Not too bad.
Am I bringing back Lazarus next week?
Lazarus doesn't exist in this realm. You absolute arse!
Yeah.
Why does the API always choose now to die?
I love this game.
Right when I'm thinking. Alright, we can wrap this up soon.
Yes.
We can really wrap this up soon. I just noticed the time. Come on, take the damage, please. There we go.
How is that all?
Yeah, that's all for now. And so, who's actually first? Who's missing from initiative order?
Me.
Did you actually? Did you
roll? I did roll. I got 20.
It's just being an ass.
Just being an ass.
Just being an ass.
There we are.
So, Raif is fighting with fishes. You hear the loud clanging and shouting of horrible sounding creatures. Where the I just put them on the map! On the wrong lane. Ah! No! It's all going wrong. Look, sod off! Roll 20, I love you and I hate you. There we go. So, from behind where the sounds were emitting, at the top of the tiny sort of cavern,
that's your mate.
You see a small group of goblins charging down the hallway. And that is the end of tonight's game.
No!
To be continued!
Dun, 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 dun.
I had a plan and everything.
Remember that plan. Write it down. Save it for next week.
Oh my word.
That was quite possibly the longest session we've had, and I'm surprised I am not knackered considering how I wrote today. I didn't even notice the time. I apologise.
That's fine.
Thank you all for coming along.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, DM.
Thank you, DM. Kind of the best for DM.
Wrote things during the good maps, all that shit. And need to draw more. But yes, we shall continue this next week.
Can't wait.